It is time. Launch Mechagodzilla. Okay, look, can I just speak to your manager then?
Controller, sir. The customer speaks of a discrepancy. What seems to be the problem?
Look, I'm sorry to have to bother you guys, but I ordered a mango twist, and what I got was a banana strawberry smoothie. And I'm allergic to strawberries, so I can't drink this. Could I just exchange it for what I ordered?
What does the computer show?
Computer shows everything is normal.
Look, I know what I ordered.
When was the order habituated?
Oh, I'd say about 10 minutes ago.
Relay surveillance audio of section 5, segment 3, series 12.
Relaying audio of section 5, segment 3, series 12.
Oh, could I just have a mango twist to go?
What is your order number?
Oh, I'm sorry. Could I have smoothie number 13, please?
013 is a banana strawberry smoothie.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so it seems I messed up the number, but I specifically said what I wanted beforehand. The number system isn't exactly intuitive anyway. Why can't you guys just use names like everyone else?
Everything is numbered here. The mango twist is 012.
Alright, look, can I just get this exchanged for maybe just a refund?
The error is yours, sir. Now, ordinarily, you would be punished, but seeing as how you are our guest, we will issue no additional charges.
Look, you know what? Forget it. I don't want a mango twist anymore. I'll just throw this away then, but you guys can better be darn sure that I'm going to go out of my way to tell people what awful service you guys run under, and the management here is nothing more than a piece of-
This summer, Samuel L. Jackson will see a really big snake-like thing.
Oh no, we got snakes, we got snakes, we gotta get out of the way, we got snakes, we're alive!
Manda is... a snake-like thing on a plane.
This film is not yet rated. They didn't bother to rate it.
A happy moment. The first time that we've been able to drive away that Monster Zero. And not suffer any damage or loss of life. Yes, celebrations are in order, are they not, my dear Godzilla? Okay, you can stop now. Can we get on with the movie yet? Is that at all possible? I command you to stop. I control you to stop. Does dancing like a nitwit, embarrassing me in front of my friends, make you happy? Because you certainly did not fool me. I'm going to count to 10. 1, 2, 3.
Why do you disrespect me so?
Did you hear? They demoted Pluto. It's no longer a planet.
But aren't people going to resist the change? What can we do to enforce conformity?
The only thing we can do, Brock, summon Godzilla. Godzilla, you have to help us. You're the only one that can destroy Pluto. It's the only way to sanctify scientific bureaucracy!
Lagoon, a wonderful place for fun, frolic, and monsters.
Stepping on the beach, doo 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 doo. Stepping on the beach, doo doo doo. Stepping on the beach, doo doo doo. Stepping on the beach, doo doo doo. Don't worry, I'm A-okay.
Must have programmed itself in some way to increase its own size.
Okay, in response to the series of peculiar events, I do have three questions I'd like to ask you.
Oh really? What are they?
First, how did he learn to make himself larger if the only data we've inserted into his massive 2 kilobyte memory is humankind's present knowledge of quantum physics, which is actually pretty limited as far as the scope of quantum physics is concerned?
Look, I don't know what quantum hizzards are. I just invented the guy. Next question.
Second question, if he made himself larger, how did he increase his mass? He clearly now weighs thousands of tons more than he did before.
I think I'll pass on that one, too. Oh boy, I'm bad at this game. What's the third question?
Third question, why did you name him Jet Jaguar? It really is a stupid name.
Because Def Leppard was taken. Oh, that's hilarious.
Hello, person who seems to have some tacit, unexplained personal connection with my character. Did you see what happened to Jet Panther?
His name is Jet Jaguar. How many times do I have to tell you, boy who I don't really know very well yet build inventions for on a seemingly frequent basis? And yes, I did see what happened to Jet Jaguar. He grew large, very large indeed.
It's funny because it's true.
Look, all I'm saying is that Jet Jaguar is the greatest invention the world has ever seen. Greater than any of the space missions. Greater than the security systems on Monsterland. Greater than most anything you can certainly find in the world. I'm telling you, Jet Jaguar is the best thing since sliced bread. I mean, sliced bread doesn't even compare to Jet Jaguar. Jet Jaguar's cool. I think Jet Jaguar can also do your homework. It programmed itself in some way to figure out how to do its homework. With its massive 2 kilobyte memory, you can't figure out what it's going to do next. You can't. It's random. It's completely random. No, you can't figure it out. It's pretty much preordained not by us, but by Jet Jaguar himself. Yes.
Shoot! The Jaguar certainly was large, ultimate light, bone fighter light, megaloman light, boom!
Watching sci-fi.
This November, a sci-fi channel unoriginal movie. What happens when the director of Garter Snake vs. Milk Snake teams up with the producer of Ultra Cube and that guy from Stargate who also played MacGyver, Richard Dean something? They will revive, with the questionable assistance of Chuck Norris, one of the coolest monsters of all time. A sci-fi event unlike any other. As we finally stop producing low-end made-for-TV CG movies, and just start producing low-end, made-for-TV movies. Varin, the unbelievable Archduke of the Triphibian Monsters. Then, let's say he fights a giant ape.
The Sci-Fi Channel disavows any notion the giant ape has any similarity to any monsters old or new, specifically monsters created in 1933. We didn't even know there was a giant ape created in 1933. We just don't. Stop pressuring us, and please don't sue us, Universal. Not that we're trying to hide anything anyway.
Thank you. Congressman Hedora will devour big business. You can count on it. Please ignore the S in this. Re-elect Congressman Hedora.
The Teacher Credit Congressional Committee has paid for and is responsible for the content of this advertising.
I feel pretty.
Now, what has Congressman Hedora really done for us? He's cut health care. He has cut school funding. He has even slashed the minimum wage. Welfare, forget about it. And he has even gone so far to be so audacious as to cut the cheese. But my friends, that is not all. He also likes to sleep with dolls. And wet the bed. So much so that he needs to wear a diaper. And don't even get us started about the fumes. So let me ask y'all something. Why would you want to re-elect a bed-wetting, doll-hugging cheese cutter when you could elect a dear friend of dear? This is the only thing he'll cut. Your taxes! Now I know you want a tax cut. Send our good friend Abira to Congress. Thank you!
The Hewan Stereo National Committee has paid for and is responsible for the content of this advertising. Well, that was hard to say.
Godzilla has a brain about the size of this peanut. It's sheer brute force, and quite tasty. While Kong is a thinking animal. His brain is considerably larger, about 10 times the size of this monkey brain. Also, quite delectable.
Pull me up in the monkey brain!
That was very succulent. Oh yes, where were we? Being instinctive rivals, I have no doubt they'll come together.
Listen to this guy. So pompous, so filling himself, talking and talking until he's blue in the face. Yes, keep going, old man. Keep spinning that yarn, because I know you aren't actually a scientist, nor are you anything close. The only thing you know how to do is make air! And you don't even make it, you exhale it with your mouth. Your big, juicy mouth! Yes, started to make perfect sense. Undeniable sense. I don't see why I didn't see it before. I must say, my hands are telepathically. But how? I'll rid myself of this unrivaled inanity. The gun! My gun is lying in the desk drawer, minding its own business, waiting for me to nearly pull it out and pull the freaking...
But gentlemen, our recent reports show that Godzilla has disappeared. Given the sudden disappearance, do you really think he'll attack Japan? I mean, he disappeared after all, so there's no sign of him. Aren't we safe if he's gone? Lacking appearance, and therefore being in a state of disappearance, I couldn't accurately hazard a guess on our safetitude, but surely it must be greater than or equal to that which it was before. So, are we safe, gentlemen? End transmission. I guess what I'm asking is, keeping this in mind, do you think he will still attack Japan?
I do. Being amphibious...
Sickening! Positively sickening! Tried to show the man is trying to feed us. I let him go on like this to try to pull that...
Air Godzilla's across between a T-Rex and a Stegosaurus!
Mr. Kien, let me ask you something. How can a T-Rex and a Stegosaurus mate? You know, how is that even possible? That's like saying a hyena is across between a cat and a dog, or a wallaby is across between a kangaroo and mountain shark!
Now, don't worry. I brought enough monkey brain for both of us. Let me just pull some more out of the cooler. Oh, where did that squirrel come from? Oh, I wonder how his brain tastes. Yeah, squirrel brain.
It's no use, sir. They were coming, they would have been here over a half an hour ago. They're never late. Sometimes fashionably late, but this is ridiculous. I'm afraid we failed again tonight. The flying saucer people are obviously on guard against the non-believer. Yes, I think it was wrong to admit this reporter to come here tonight. She's jinxing the whole mission. You don't even believe in them, I suppose.
Well, they're very interesting.
If that's the best you can do, forget it. The brain waves of your cynical thoughts have gone up there to those ships, bounced around a couple times in their highly advanced heads, and have ricocheted back here, creating an electromagnetic barrier impossible to permeate. Your brain waves, that is.
Did you say brain waves?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no, really. There's no such thing as brain waves.
Look, young lady, there's a lot more you need to learn about many things besides brain waves. Strange and terrible things. The Bermuda Triangle, Daylight Savings Time, and the Iowa Primary. Those are just three prime examples. Also, can you tell me what month is this?
What month? Why, it's January. January 8th, to be exact.
I didn't ask for the date. That was unnecessary information. But nevertheless, don't you realize it's the middle of the winter? Therefore, how do you explain this heat wave? The newspapers are full of explanations, none of which seem to make much sense. Now, aren't you worried about it yourself?
Yes.
Yes, of course.
But can't that be explained by greenhouse gas emissions?
Poppycock, nothing of the sort. It's a mystery. The incomprehensible is one of the facts of existence in the solar system and throughout the intergalactic structure as well, extending all the way out to Andromeda and the large Magellanic clouds. It's even a fact of existence on Coruscant, of all places. How do you explain Jedi?
And now you're going to tell me, I suppose, that this poor old planet of ours is about to blow up. Go kaputs. Explodey-wodey-wodey.
I don't believe the Earth will explode. Yet. That's still a few years off. But in the meantime, I know something terrible is going to happen soon. Maybe the saucer people can warn us what to expect. They can tell us so we can warn the world.
Look up there. There's one.
Let me see. It's a false alarm. It's a shooting star. What kind of person can't tell the difference between a flying saucer and a shooting star? But sir, it turned 90 degrees and shot right back up into space. It was a shooting star. I'm the one who called it. I say it's a shooting star. Stick that through your thick, meaty head!
Oh, hey, do you see one over there?
Yes, oh, up there too! A boom. La la la, I'm on the way home. Da da da. Duh. doo doo doo. I'm on my way to bed. Ta-da!
Hi, this is Miles Imhoff, and this is the directive commentary for Gorosaurus X Megaguirus. I had the idea to have Gorosaurus try to squish Megaguirus when I saw a dragonfly, and it kind of creeped me out pretty bad, and I tried to crush it. Then I thought to myself, hey! What if I was Gorosaurus and the dragonfly was Megaguirus? And it all just fell right into place. The tune, that is. The cartoon. Trivia for you. This tune literally took 5 minutes of production and 3 seconds of pre-production and yeah.
Are you telling me that you people aren't even human?
That's right.
And tell me, what kind of freaks are you people?
The type of freak that can survive even under the worst possible conditions. Switch to emergency lighting!
Right!
A penguin!
Dun, 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 dun.
You see what I mean when I talk about human receptacles.
I still don't get it. What's going on around here? Are they penguins or something? I'm not even following the plot anymore. Oh, this is really sucky. Can't figure out what's going on. Well, I'll audition for that Gamera movie. To the next studio.
Give me the tape back.
The tape?
I watched you picking it up.
But it isn't yours, is it? Now get it back from him.
Not here.
What? What have you done with it? Where is it? Now, where?
Oh, gosh. I think he's fainted.
Huh? Huh. He must have thought it was a gun.
All right, folks, let's start the countdown!
'Something Nation and an Arbor Day Foundation and a something, 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 save a tree!
Translation. Could you show me to your bibliotheque? I mean, library.
I am the number 7. I come after 6 and before 8. I'm in the sentence, and it's not really even a sentence. It's more of an exclamation. Thank you for clicking on the lamest Easter egg ever.
Like somebody's walking on their hands and knees.
My good man, you look like a grade A weirdo. Aren't you supposed to be a quadruped?
Ah, I'm Dr. Baragon Van Horn. For years, I've had monsters ask me,
hey, how can I walk on all fours even though I have long, human-like hind legs?
Well, the answer is actually surprisingly simple. You need CGI.
But, Professor, what is CGI? Is it Common Gateway Interface?
No, no, my young friend. CGI is when you solve a problem that could be accomplished through time and patience with supposedly sophisticated computer-generated animation instead.
Animation? Do you mean like anime?
No, my surprisingly simple young friend. I mean like Jurassic Park animation.
But, Professor... Professor Hornswoggle, how can CGI help our friend Anguillus?
I am so glad you asked. In the old days, monsters had three ways to solve their inability to portray four-legged walking. Hiding behind vegetation. Hiding behind dust. Or they just used sugar to chase the blues away. But now we have computers. First, we import Anguirus. Second, we erase his hind legs. Third, we create a wire mesh skeleton. Fourth, we add in the skin. Fifth, we add color. Finally, we erase the whole dang thing and create an entirely new computer-generated Anguirus.
Wow, technology can do all that?
It sure can, Timmy. It sure can. But and Anguirus looks just as realistic as before, if not more so. Well, sometimes. At night, he looks really great, but during the day, he's got kind of that bluish tint, but people will never notice. And what do if they bring it up?
We have to shun and deride them at all costs. Hollywood's future depends on it.
Attaboy, Timmy. Attaboy. They got a gun in my back. Oh my. Oh, help me, somebody out there, please. I can't stop laughing, I can't see him at all. Oh man, help me. Oh no. Oh, the tune's over, please exit out of the window.
It's a sphere! A highly advanced computer-generated sphere! It is so advanced, it's got a wire mesh skeleton!
Sigh! I wish I wasn't such a little Godzilla!
I believe that I can grant such an innocent request! Do you desire to be taller, me boy?
Do I ever, extremely creepy stranger, sir?
Then sample my wares. One prodigious potion to cure what ails your poor unfortunate soul.
Awesome! What do I do with it?
You drink it. Duh!
Wait a second, G. Are we sure that this dude is on the up and up?
Buzz off, Trifib! I wanna be taller!
Very well then, a bit of fair warning, chum. Drink too much, and it will kill you. However, if you fail to drink enough, then it will most certainly kill you!
Wow, I like those odds! No, you were right all along, Baron. I should just say no.
That's the spirit. Now buzz off, mysterious little stranger.
You've won this round, you little pukes.
Bum.
At Titanosaurus's used cars, we make sure that you walk away with...
Fine. The finest used cars.
A used car! When my daddy founded this business 65 million years ago, I never thought it would take off like it did. But it did. Take off. Like it did. It did. Is there anybody out there that can beat these prices, let alone match them? If they can, bring them on here.
So I can deal with them personally!
Some people say that I'm just a little bit crazy. Ha ha! We have all the greatest makes and models! Just look at this genuine 1975 Ford Pinto. So what are you waiting for?
The rate of global warming kills us all!
Come on down and buy a used car today. And I'll fill up your gas tank. I'll bake you a pizza, and I'll file your taxes, and allow you to give me a purple Nerfle. I guarantee you that no offer will be refused.
Unless it sucks.
And financing is guaranteed.
Unless your credit sucks.
Titanosaurus' used cars. At the corner of Mifune's Place and Ogasawara Boulevard. Visit us today. We will be coming away. Whoa! I am okay.
Titanosaurus' used cars is not liable for your well-being when you purchase or drive one of our vehicles. Lawsuits aren't going to help. We can afford better lawyers than you can. So ha, we win again, you lose again, you stinking consumer slime. I wipe my nose at your suffering. With sincere feelings of greed, hatred, and vice, I'm your local used car salesman, and I approve this message.
If it triggers a real volcanic eruption, Godzilla will be charbroiled alive, slowly cooked, simmering, rotisserie style.
What a horrible death.
It won't kill him. Couldn't. Wouldn't. Shouldn't. Wait, scratch that last one.
What do you mean? It's gotta kill him, Professor. Did you suddenly get hit with a stupid stick or something? Jeez. Lava's over 1,000 degrees, huh? Get it through your head. He's gonna be dead. Hey, that was rhyming. I was rhyming in time.
Yeah! It was radical. The other night at the reactor. Didn't you sense it? The beast has a purpose. 20 years ago, Godzilla appeared for the first time. 30 years ago, Godzilla appeared for the very first time. Before that, he was only a legend. Before that, he was only a dinosaur. And before that, he was only an egg. Godzilla's a warning. A warning to every one of us. When mankind puts a Komodo dragon in a microwave, monsters are born. I'm just trying to send him home. To Monsterland. Via a volcano. Are we still on? Didn't the scene change yet?
I think they're still looking for Godzilla.
Well, they should have found him by now.
How do you say?
Just kind of feels like they should have found him by now. I don't know. I'm just trying to make conversation. I'm sure something more interesting is going on somewhere else, but...
Well, who knows?
This tea could really use a sprucing up. Does anybody got a Dr. Pepper or something? I don't know.
You will watch this. Let no joyful voice be heard. Let no man look up at the sky with hope. And let this day be cast, and we ready to wake. is Zora! No!
Crap. There's only one way to solve the dilemma of quote-unquote fantasy matches. You need a hypno-wheel.
Yes, you were right all along. A 3-foot-tall Angus with a slightly confused Jack Sparrow could in fact beat a fully grown Baragon with a giant lightsaber.
Thank you, Hypno-Wheel!
The Hypno-Wheel, available at retailers we're too lazy to mention.
What about Grungy?
Where can I get one of these Hypno-Nautic Wheels?
Sorry, Mr. President, you're too old.
Ah, crud.
The Hypno-Wheel, developed by NASA in 1969 for, classified reasons.
But alas, have ye a flask filled to the brim with potions and bejeweled beverages to quench my insurmountable thirst? I believe that this constitutes fair compensation for your impeccable service! Assassin! An attempt on my very being, is it? What brand of sick, twisted charlatan would pour such a prodigiously potent poison upon her very patrons? Well, that explains everything, I guess, sir.
Don't worry, there's enough oil-based paint for both of us. Let me just reach into the cooler. Oh, where did that hamster come from? Huh. It looks like it's communicating telepathically with you.
Shut up!
I don't get it! Ah!
Do you remember all your favorite public domain children's songs?
now hear them played by that melancholy guitarist from Godzilla vs. Ghidorah, who will play those songs only in depressing minor key. Mary had a little lamb. Her fleece was white as snow. Her fleece was as white as the snowiest snow. Snowier than the snowiest of the snowy snow. They need some wool.
Order now when you'll receive other such melancholy favorites as Ring Around the Rosie, Sprickerinky Dinky something, Boom Boom Diddle Edda Waddle, whatever that is, This Old Man He Played Eight, and of course, Bingo.
B-I-N-G-M-O-T.
Order today!
Oh yeah, Mr. Guitar Man! Well, I play the ukulele! Ah!
Yeah, you've reached the hotline. Ah! You apparently want the Melancholy Guitarist album. I'm so mad you ain't getting it!
It's time for another good idea, bad idea. Good idea. Looking for monsters in Loch Ness. Bad idea. Looking for monsters in the end.
Welcome, one and all, to the Godzilla vs. the Fish Monster Radio Drama Hour, brought to you by the fine fellows at Coca-Cola. Because when you wish to spin a yarn at the speed of a locomotive, you'll require a medicinal dose of grand old Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola, produced from the finest cocaine. Yes, sir, the bona fide Coke. Now, without further ado, the battlefield, folks. Oh, there! Right there, I see him. I see the brute, the cad. There's Godzilla from out of the hour, packing power as big as a tower. He's just emerged from somewhere afar and is ready for a battle to kick the tar and feathers out of whom or whatever's brain is lame enough to fathom a rumble with the beast from a bajillion thousand fathoms. Can't argue with that brand of might, folks. Can't argue with that rhyming. Oh, no siree, not even with the assistance of Mr. Woodrow Wilson himself. Oh, wait, what's this? It seems that our boys in uniform have something to say about this derailed trolley. This main event? Well, let's listen in, shall we? A bushel of apples says the scaly behemoth prevails.
and the pilots float serenely to the ground suspended from silky paramashoots. Oh, wait! Oh no! This cannot be happening, folks! One of their paramedica shooter chutes failed to open! Oh, the pilot is in a free fall! Oh, what a catastrophe, folks! What? I don't believe it, folks! Godzilla snatched that poor fellow from a certain death! Oh, he's a good sport! A real swell guy! He just let him down on the ground, as if nothing had ever occurred! Now they're shaking hands! Oh, man! Let's have a hand for Godzilla, folks! Let's have a hand! What's that on the horizon? Oh, folks, this is just getting worse by the second. It's a disc with a wish, the size of 47 Model Ts placed side by side. Oh, no, Herbert Hoover's mortal enemy from the Atlantic. It's... Can it be, folks? It is! Fishra, the mammoth trout. Oh, it's a fish and it's a mammoth, folks. It's a hunker of a catch. I've never seen gills that size in all my life, folks. Oh, he'll put up a fight. Look at that gaze. Sharp as the pointed edge of a checkered coat. Steely as a lumberjack. What? Oh, no, folks. I can't bear to watch. A phantasmagorical fray for the ages. A dynamite blow to all that is decent. What can it be? It is. Godzilla has thrown down the gauntlet. A challenge, as it were. He's making light of the situation, folks. Oh, where are you, Calvin Coolidge? Who will prevail? He doesn't know what he's in for. Oh, this is terrible. The big lug will get torn asunder from limb to shining limb if he's not careful. Ah, the insanity. It's too gruesome. Put your kitties to bed, folks. This is getting very ugly. There's tartar sauce everywhere, folks. Oh, I can't bear to watch. Ladies and gentlemen, what we're seeing here is pure pandemonium at its finest. Oh, no, the oyster crackers. And, oh, dear, the clam chowder. Wait, it's... No, it cannot be! It's Manhattan clam chowder. Oh, the horror. The utter disgustingness of it all. Godzilla's starting with the appetizers. Oh, this is... Oh, no. Unthinkable. I think he meant to order New England clam chowder, folks. Oh, folks. He could use a napkin. Oh, thank goodness, folks. The big tuna managed to escape unharmed by the skin of his hydroquatic and therefore sinisterly, evil and violently vile teeth. But he'll be back. I'll guarantee you, folks, by the hair on a Bolshevik's nose. Ladies and gentlemen, what you just heard was a roar. A hollow victory. Not anything tangible nor necessarily real. Not a lasting peace nor a return to normalcy by any stretch. Not even an accord as we know it, nor the click of a pair of ruby slippers, nor a handshake per se, or a swell howdy-do, or a here's looking at you, but something yes. Can you sense it? There's certainly something in the air. Well, there you have it, folks. The whole and entire engagement. The heated exchange. Stay tuned for everyone's favorite radio quiz show. What's the color of my blue blazer? For every Herb, Frank, and Harry is the winner. Thank you and good night, fellow monster lovers. I wish you good luck and happy sailing. And a fine, rickety, sprackety, diddly, medley do. Have a happy 1934, folks. 1,934. Thank you. Peace out, yo.
The mammoth trout! Oh, I screwed that up. Trout, not trout. There's tartar sauce. That's not right. The Latin. No, not at all. Ladies and gentlemen, what you just heard was a roar, a hollow victory, not anything tangible nor necessarily real, not a lasting peace, nor a return to normalcy by any stretch, not even an accord as we know it, nor the click of a pair of ruby slippers, nor a handshake per sway or sway. Oh, jeez, I got that far! It's sway! It's per se! Ah!
Until this battle station is fully operational, we are vulnerable. The Monster Alliance is too well equipped. They're more dangerous than you realize. Seriously, they're really, 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 really dangerous.
Dangerous to your starfleet, Commander Caesar. Not to this battle station. So, there.
The Rebellion will continue to gain support in the UNGCC.
The UNGCC will no longer be of any concern to us. I have just received word that Emperor Gebra has dissolved the Council permanently. And literally, he actually disintegrated it. It was fairly gruesome, but I digress. The last remnants of the Old Republic have been swept away.
Well, that's impossible! How will the Emperor maintain control without the mind-numbing bureaucracy that we've all grown to love and hate at the same time?
The regional governors now have direct control over their territories. Fear will keep the local systems in line. Fear of this battle station. And of our new color-coded alert system.
And what of the Rebellion? If the rebels have obtained a complete tactical readout of this station, it is possible, however unlikely, that they might not invite us to their pool party this Saturday.
Now, exactly what are you referring to?
What I meant to say is that it is possible, however unlikely, that they might find a weakness and exploit it. By using the plans, that is.
The plan you are referring to will soon be back in our hands. A cold, clammy, imperial hands.
Any attack made by the rebels against this station would be a useless gesture. And we'd laugh at them until we'd wet our pants. And they'd cry like a bunch of wee, wee little babies. Regardless, this station is now the ultimate power in the universe. I suggest we use it.
Don't be too proud of this technologically terrifying merry-go-round of destruction, mayhem, and havoc that you have constructed. Equipped with 30,000 hands-free restrooms and several hundred popular fast food franchises, the ability to destroy our planet is insignificant compared to that of the G-Force.
You and your sorcerer's ways, Darth Mechagodzilla. Always good for a laugh. Ha ha! Your sad devotion to that ancient, farce-like thing hasn't helped you to conjure up those stolen A-tracks, nor has it given you clairvoyance enough to find the rebels' hidden fortress, trademark, on Monster Island.
I find your lack of intelligence highly disturbing.
Enough of this. Mechagodzilla, get me an ice cream sandwich and a Mountain Dew. Oh, right. And a release.
As you wish.
This bickering is pointless. I suggest we all retreat to the Solarium and play a few games of squash. And upon our mental rejuvenation, Mechagodzilla will provide us with the location of the Rebels' hidden base. We will then crush the Rebellion with one swift stroke. Much like what Mechagodzilla just tried to do to Admiral Manda's windpipe.
They're magically delicious!
On the good ship, Lollipop. This is speeding trip to the candy shop, where the bonbons play. On a sunny beach of peppermint bay.
Reach the stain, they must have been destroyed. Please, Darth Mechagodzilla, get us out of this freaking asteroid field. We're gonna die in here.
Stop whining, Captain Ghidorah. They are alive. So you've lost a few ships. Big flippin' deal. Look at me, I've got three heads. I'm scared of a few little asteroids. Baby.
Darth Mechagodzilla, please, I beg your forgiveness.
Don't grumble either. Just obey my orders. I want every ship available to sweep the asteroid field until they are found. You will find them or die a tragically horrible death in the process. Enjoy!
Darth Mechagodzilla, the Emperor demands that you make contact with him.
Audible sigh. That man and his demands. Very well, move the ship out of the asteroid field so we can send a clear transmission.
Yes, Darth Mechagodzilla. Wait, do you want us to move up or down out of the asteroid field?
This is space. It doesn't matter.
Yes, Darth Mechagodzilla. Understood.
What is thy being, my master? I have felt. But wait a second, I am Godzilla, or at least I was before King Kong cut off my limbs and left me to die on a volcanic planet. But I digress. I wonder how King Kong is doing right now. Oh wait, yes. I killed him! Or he kind of disappeared in his cloak, something along those lines. I can't quite figure that one out. Oh wait, we were talking about Minya, right? Are you sure the boy is my son? Did we do a DNA test? Have we been non-moric purgates? If he could be turned to the dark side of the G-Force, then he could become a powerful ally. Well, eventually, it would take a little work, but you know.
Yes, if he could become the asset, yes, it's done.
He will join us or cry. I want them alive. No disintegrations.
As you wish.
I am that Boba Lava. I will get you for that. Never mind. I don't even care anymore.
If
you not turn to the dark side of the G-Force, then you will die! I mean, get down! Really badly!
Father! He's missing terribly, but this is still annoying nonetheless! Help me! Avenge somebody!
Time for that, you naughty old man!
Did we destroy the little whelp? My apprentice?
Sure, whatever. So, Brava, let's ditch the old coot.
And so they ruled the galaxy, his father and son. And Mechagodzilla turned back to the light side of the G-Force. But only after he sat through 30 mind-numbing hours of Dr. Phil. The end.
What brand of backstabbing low-life apprentice would abandon his very emperor? Ah, crap! Well, this is quite a predicament now, isn't it? Oh, man. I really have to pee, and I don't relish attempting that sort of thing whilst trapped in such a tight spin. Oh, I'm going to miss the office this Thursday. Oh, that really stinks.
I am the controller of Planet Moon to the people of the Earth. I command that you obey the following orders.
Obey, fools!
You will place the Earth under our absolute control and be governed as our colony. If you do not obey these orders willingly and immediately, we will destroy your civilization, as well as all of your pachinko parlors and karaoke machines.
Destroy!
I repeat the order. Earth will only continue to exist as a colony of Planet Moon. Maestro Ifukube, can't we have a cube? Oh, no, we would have to pay royalties. Even though we've evolved beyond all royalties and copyrights, sadly, we are still vulnerable to lawsuits.
No! We're loyal!
Yes, that's right, Er. We've advanced beyond all mortality. Oh, wait, 3 seconds have passed. We regret to inform you that you have not yet complied with our order. We interpret this as a negative reply. You're screwed.
Screwed!
We are prepared, therefore, to conquer the Earth. We have stationed King Ghidorah in the Western Hemisphere. And King Ghidorah is completely controlled by our computers using magnetic waves. I don't know if you know what magnetic waves are, but they are pretty advanced. They are only matched by the sheer power of ColecoVisions and 5,000 analog beta tapes and a guitar.
Guitar!
We also control Godzilla and Rodan through similar vague 80s references. These monsters can destroy you and together can conquer the entire Earth. However, we will delay the order to kill for yet another 3 seconds. This is your last chance. We await your capitulation.
Capitulate!
It's not funnier. Do you even know what it means?
Yeah, I can spell it too!
Yes, we are excellent spellers. We are unsurpassed, even by the likes of nerdy sixth graders. They have yet to heed our warnings. I'm starting to wonder if the destruction of our ship will hinder the transmission of our mind control signal.
Don't get your panties in a knot! The mind control signal is safe aboard the ship! Oh, wait.
Check it out, y'all! Check it out! Check it out, y'all! Check it out! Don't be afraid when I turn the party out, cause I come from the moon and I carry all I got! I got a quad laser! It will amaze ya! Something! Check it out, y'all! Check it out! Well, for those of you who are interested, I finally see behind an asteroid. Oh, I can't wait till I land.
There is no reasoning behind why I'm here. I'm just taking up space, aren't I?
Meanwhile, in the corner for a camera, Thomas Porter, and Albert Thornton.
Mr. Schindel! But sir, you must leave your office! It's heading your way!
Yes, I know that, but this is the way I want it. Let me have it my way. You never let me have it my way. I nearly died on Lagos Island, along with my entire garrison. But the dinosaur saved us all. Well, except that one guy he stepped down. He's okay now, but I bet that all the prosperity I built is being destroyed by the same dinosaur at this very moment. And there's nothing I can do about it. It's very ironic, don't you think? Darth Vader turning out to be Luke Skywalker's father and all. Yes, I realize it's a non sequitur, but let me have it my way. Sure.
And so, Mr. Schindler and Godzilla went on to become friends, and they went on very long adventures together.
What? Where's the bleak melodrama? Where's the cruelty and violence? I'm shooting through the vast reaches of space for 2 straight weeks, and this is what happens in my stead. Well, this is all going to have to change. Somehow. I'll figure something out. Someday. Seriously, I mean it. I'll figure out something. I know what you're thinking. You're thinking that old Gabby is lying to your face. Well, maybe I am lying. Or maybe I'm just not telling the truth. You decide.
We are most displeased with the outcome of this part, too.
We're displeased!
That was weak, Er.
Shut it!
Oh, like that was so much better.
Good news! We own the giant egg now. Can you imagine how many diners we'll be able to open just with the excess egg yolk alone?
No diners. We're going to hatch the egg. Do you realize just how much we'll, realize from a natural tourist attraction such as this?
Oh, I'd say a rough estimate of about, let's say, $300. Conservatively speaking, that is.
You think too small. At least $1,000.
$1,000? You're crazy! Go away! You are too crazy for me!
Ha 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 ha. Though I can see why you would think so, I am not, I assure you. Now shut up and sit down. We'll need to build an incubator. Out of glass? No. Polycarbonate casing? No. Saran wrap? Yes, the most durable substance known to egg salad. We'll warm it until it hatches. Then we'll paint the eggshells and sell them as cheap pottery. Ha 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 ha. I've got it all planned out. Soon we'll be able to afford that summer home in Hawaii.
Wow. $1,000?
$1,000? Ha! At least 2,000, if you catch my drift.
2,000? Now I'm convinced! You're absolutely insane!
But your planning is wrong! You must return the egg!
Spies? You let spies in?
Oh, maybe a couple.
We are not spies! We are the Shobujin Buddies from Hartford Island, Inland Island, home of the Never Corporation. Please, return the egg!
Let's grab them! They're like a couple of walking $100 bills.
$100? You think too small. Ha ha ha. At least 150. Huh? Where did they go?
You evil men! We are sick and tired of this! We will now shoot electricity at you!
Oh, I'm getting electrocuted! This is not cool! Why are you doing this to me? All I wanted to do was sell you for money!
We will now take the egg by force and convince for good.
And so, Mothra towed the egg back to Infant Island using a giant rope. That is all.
You have brought back old Dinor.
The egg is not dinner. You have enraged us. Prepare to be electrocuted.
Oh no, I asked for this one.
Did I hear a fight? So, have you two been making out again?
I told you to stop saying that!
It's time for another good idea, bad idea. Good idea. Eating shiitake mushrooms. Bad idea. Eating matango mushrooms. That I did, Skullhead. That I did.
Oh, that tickles me something funny there. Oh, oh, the hilarity is unspeakable. Oh, I can't stop laughing here. I stole your bed. Oh, 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 man. You've been out of work for so many years that I just come right in and steal your bed like that. Oh, man. You've got egg on your face. Go ahead. Oh, man. The fake left answer. Stop here. I'm done.
Rico! Godzilla!
That is Minya! How could you make that mistake? Seriously, what's wrong with you?
I just thought...
You thought? I highly doubt that!
He just startled me, is all.
Startled? The poor thing can't even squish a bug! I gotta squish it! Not to mention the obvious height difference between Godzilla and Minya, and the fact that Minya sounds like a sick donkey. And the fact that he's holding a flower, and the fact that he's wearing a tic-tac with sunglasses.
Oh, quite snazzy.
How could you have completely missed those signals?
I love you.
I like how you just expect that there's going to be an Easter egg this week. I like how you're all like, oh, I know there's going to be an Easter egg because there's been an Easter egg for the past 7 years. Well, too bad you ain't getting one, so just take that and shove it in a faucet or something and stop bothering me and stop clicking on things. And anybody who's like right-clicking so they can like see stuff that they're not supposed to, don't do that. That really sucks. I mean, come on. Alright, well, I got my point across. So, anyone gonna see Spider-Man? And I don't know, I'm kind of waiting for Pirates. Shrek? That looks like it's gonna be good. Yeah.
Anti-nuclear energy bacteria. So, this is it. Gah!
Huh? I can see you.
That weirdo lethal weapon! Now seriously, was that necessary? Well, if just as easily used pseudo-swears. Observe, shoot, darn, we're the lethal weapon!
Wow, that was much better, cause darn it!
That's the spirit. But we aren't grizzled prospectors. Still, that was a decent first try. Oh wait, that civilian agent is still shooting us.
Where did they go?
I must shoot them!
Ah! Oh no!
I'm going to mess you up! Big time!
Bring it home!
I seriously have no clue what you just said.
Let us commence with your inevitable destruction!
Well, there is no arguing with that brand of logic, is there?
No, there is not! Stop wasting time, you cowardly son of a...
Oh, no, you didn't!
Oh, yes, I did!
Enough of this nonsense! Let's stop the match!
Boom.
No, this feels way too familiar. Why am I spinning out of control yet again? I seriously have some kind of anchor management issue. I didn't even want to fight the Shogun in the first place. They pressured me into it. They coaxed and cajoled me into fighting them. With electricity, no less. I call my attack the Gather Gun. He calls theirs the Shogun Chakra. Mine has a better name.
Greetings, I am Senior Political Analyst Julian Ivers, Space Godzilla III, and this is the May 27th edition of Pundit Patrol. Joining me tonight is our resident Starbucks connoisseur, Salazar Mercutio Dutalios.
Hello, hey, I'm human people! On the light! On the light!
An honor roll student and chess aficionado at a posh local high school in Connecticut, Baron Julio Berdoggi.
It's good to be here, friend!
And of course, finally, our resident raving lunatic, Gabra.
Where am I?
Today's topic, funding for public schools. Deutalius?
Well, I disagree to my very core. I think that any way we can screw the younger generation is an opportunity that we must take advantage of at any and every juncture. If you ask me, it's all pork barrel politics anyway, Space Godzilla.
A most valid point. Varen, your rebuttal?
Well, I'm completely opposed to Gabra's stance on the issue. Obviously, funding schools is far more important. But what would Gabra know about that? He was trying to sell me and Little Godzilla a prodigious potion on the playground.
Lies! All lies! I've had it with all of these lies! I'm leaving! Because of the lies.
Hold on just one moment. I'm told that we've received a phone call. I wasn't aware this was a phone-in show. Yes? Oh, it's Dr. Beragon Van Horn, local quack.
I'm Dr. Beragon Van Horn. On the subject of the medical aspect of the matter, I must declare that Gabra is most in the right here. As a doctor, I need not explain myself except to give a vague, all-encompassing statement on the matter like, let's say, medical evidence supports my view, so screw you. Also, as a side note, take any and every medicine that you see on TV commercials, especially those that sponsor news shows such as this. Because why would multi-billion-dollar corporations such as drug companies with their greedy, corrupt, mittens and the beeswax of even more sinisterly corrupt FDA actually go out of their little old way and lie to you, huh? On a completely unrelated subject matter, anyone who experiences acute exhaustion following intensive physical activity or chronic grogginess prior to habitual nocturnal unconsciousness should seriously ask their doctor about the newest wonder drug on the market, Snake Poison SB1. SB1, please use in recommended doses. Pregnant women should not even touch or look at SB1. Consult your doctor if you experience prolonged periods of cardiac arrest while on SB1. Beg your doctor to write you a prescription ASAP because you're so dang hypnotized by the idiot bars that you think everything I'm saying is completely infallible. Space Godzilla.
And with that, I'm afraid that's all the time that we have.
But there's still so much more that needs to be said on the subject.
I said that's all the time that we have.
That is all the time we have.
Thank you all for tuning in. Until next time, keep patrolling those pundits. No, wait, that doesn't make any sense. We'll figure something out.
The funding of schools is a waste of money, an astronomical abomination, the monetary aspect of which should be reallocated to us.
Give us the money!
Where is Mr. Laser? I'm afraid our threats require leverage.
I'm pounded for SB1! Dude, that stuff is whack! Oh wait, I think my heart just stopped!
That is the least of your concerns at this point,
A coherent tone herein shall there be not. I am merely standing here inconspicuously, minding my own business, merely pondering the English translation of this cartoon's title.
I wonder if I'm a dinosaur.
Oh, snippity snap!
I'm back after an 11 dude hiatus.
Got an external flash and a 2,000mm telephoto lens.
Would you just shut up for once? Jeez!
Oh, if I had a sidecar, I could hire on a sidekick. Oh, I wonder how expensive sidekicks are nowadays.
Mush mush. Hi, Katagiri this.
What?
This is Katagiri. What's up?
You remember that thing? That thing we were trying to salvage from the bottom of the ocean? Well, it's kind of moving now through the air, and I don't know why, but it's headed in your direction. Oh, I'm scared.
I could seriously care less. You know those missiles? Those missiles we were talking about over dinner last night? Well, I'm under the distinct impression that they'll go through Godzilla
like crap through a goose. Oh, you what? Oh, come on. Ah, oh, I think I just vomited in my own mouth a little bit there. Oh, ugh. Crap. I love that word. Really, I do. Crap, crap, crap. Poop.
I'm sorry. Let me compose myself.
Trap.
Oh my, I've never heard that sound in my entire life. It's like a mix of three different sounds that couldn't possibly go together, with a lurid resonance undescribable even in the most gruesome horror novel.
I'm sorry, it's just that thing you said, it was disgusting.
You mean my commentary on how those magnificent warheads will penetrate Godzilla's hide in the same way that digested matter shoots through the gastrointestinal system of a...
So, can we fire them now? The missiles, I mean.
Yes, commence. Those crap bullets will poop through
Transzilla like feces through a bag of...
I hope that nerd fellow doesn't bust a cat play!
In 1954, Godzilla's first raided Tokyo. Dr. Serizawa attempted to destroy the beast, but the oxygen destroyer backfired, and he merely strained his arm in the process. It could never be used again. Dr. Serizawa's handwriting was so terrible that it would have required both of his eyes in order to read his own blueprints.
I remember that, Godzilla. He was a real jerk. Under his appearance, giant monsters have often raided us, but have spared mainland Asia, India, and much of the remainder of planet Earth. I wonder why.
Mothra, a giant monster in the South Pacific. She frequently sold samples of paint at wholesale prices, but left the content of her jars ambiguous, leading to many unpleasant situations and several lawsuits. The investigation was despite her, but she just kept absorbing the beam. She attempted to dive at the end of the to defeat this terrible monster, but they were quickly replaced by the Nathan Pack, which we thought had a much cooler name.
That isn't all. There were two other monsters that attacked us. Strange and terrible monsters.
Gabra's sudden appearance led to the development of the A-Cycle Light Ray, a device of immensely hacking proportions which really didn't do much of anything. We still haven't defeated him. And recently, we had to deal with the arrival of yet another monster, Zizora. Zizora was summoned to destroy us when he made a deal with Daisy James to raise the Rotengo from the deck, but he failed to live up to our end of the bargain, since space gods lived to serve a force justice for 100 years.
And so ends our shameless name-dropping of random fellow entity.
Time we were attacked, Tokyo was rebuilt after the devastation, thanks to the efforts of our citizens. We've been way, way too stubborn to move to another prefecture. Cheers, citizens.
Stop kicking my face. Ow. Please stop. Ow. Please stop.
Now are you really going to hit a lady?
I wasn't planning on it. Wait, are you really a lady or just some freakish alien that looks like a lady? Boy, I am in a pickle, aren't I? Well, how about this? Do you promise to never, ever, ever try to obliterate mankind again?
Sure.
Well, that's good enough for me.
5 minutes later.
All of you puny human cattle, bow down before your supreme commander, the new ruler of planet Earth, that alien lady from that movie you saw that really didn't do so well at the box office. You know Godzilla Final Wars, that one.
Perhaps I made a slight miscalculation. are nuts.
Welcome to Little Godzilla Throw Session, featuring me, Little Godzilla! Die the dirty and the joy of living in RPGs! I mean, just murder the three corners and we're crossed into the chaos and the complete carnage of the attack in
your brain! Oh, Little Godzilla? Oh, I just wanted to tell you that your school clothes are ready.
Not now, Mum! I'm thrashing my axe to and fro and whatnot and so on and so forth!
Oh, okay, dear. When you're finished, could you find some time to clean your room?
You're not the boss of me!
But seriously, yes, just wait till I'm done with my YouTube broadcast, please.
Okay, sweetie. Mommy loves you. I'll bring in some cookies when you're ready.
Oh, cookies!
I'm right now! No! Cookies are the bard's way of keeping us in line! Only through shadow, pseudo, non-conformist, legendary Godzilla can we truly break free of my judgment for typical values, such as the dreaded movie of room escape! NBC must see the dangers of pompous arrogance of royal crown killer!
Mom! I need you to drive me to the store. My G-string broke.
Oh, dear. I told you those thongs were a bad idea.
Mom! I mean the G-string on my guitar. Don't tell them about my undergarments. Seriously, I don't know what she's talking about. Ugh.
Oh, Richard James, little dude. My ukulele feeling a mighty bit lonely.
We've had way too many darn good years without the Sith. I ain't letting some cloaked freak beat that winning streak.
Master Baragon! I take it General Mogra has been defeated. I must say you're here sooner than expected. What gives?
In the name of the UNGCC, you're under arrest, Chancellor.
Are you coming on to me, Master Jedi? Wait a second, I mean, are you threatening me, Master Jedi? Please fix the cue cards.
The UNGCC is gonna decide your fate, and it ain't gonna be so pretty.
I am the UNGCC!
Wait, no you're not. Don't you dare try to confuse me.
It's treason, then! Or something.
Oh crap, he's got a glowy sword too!
I've got a glowy sword and everything, I'm gonna leave!
Such a weak old man!
You are under arrest, you big meanie.
Chancellor, I got your groceries. I'll put them in the kitchen. Whoa!
I told you it would come to this! Didn't I tell you? And you thought I was crazy. Well, that was crazy!
The oppression of the Sith will never return. You lose, Chancellor Dirtbag.
No. You will fry! No! I'm becoming hideous!
Oh, you don't look any different than you did before.
Help me! Only I can save Padme! Who's Padme? Okay. Only I can get you that four-wheeler you've been wanting.
Oh, goody.
Several years later.
And so that's how I became the Mega Godzilla.
Meanwhile, I went into exile and became a doctor. Fancy that.
It won't be very long before they search up in this area. Perhaps we should try hiding behind a moving bush again. They seem to be easily fooled.
Hey, wait! I have an idea!
Seriously, I wasn't aware you had the capacity to manifest one.
What?
Never mind. What's your idea?
Let's wake up Godzilla!
What are you smoking?
No, I think we ought to try. If we wake Godzilla up, they'll stop looking for us, and many will needlessly die in the process. It's a win-win situation.
I don't quite understand your logic.
I thought it was fairly self-explanatory. Here's my theory. If we have Dio use her magical powers to wake up Godzilla, then we'll be in business.
I don't have any magical powers.
Sure you do. You just don't realize it yet. Just try out a spell or something.
Alright. I heard this one somewhere before. How about Abracadabra?
Ah, crap. You just killed Godzilla. You just killed his foot fungus. Well, at least that's a start. Now, if you could only actually wake him up, that would be really great. Okay, just a thought.
Oh, hey, my name is, Ziller.
Hi, Ziller!
Okay, are you all gonna be like a talking like that throughout the entire session in unison like that? Should I be getting used to that? Oh, well, anyway, I've been without a face for 3 straight months here, which is kinda hard because my primary diet used to consist solely of the scary stuff, but I didn't realize how much of a monster I'd become until I jumped a fisherman with my life version. Oh, he's okay now. Yeah, but still.
Hi! Hi, Ryan!
What's that? Sandy Slay! I am the unseen one in here! I can't exist! I can't even stand fast! I'm a dolphin! What's the story of monsters, you say? Dolphins don't fit! They're mammalian!
These dolphins is even worse, and the reason you're here is because you are flying under the influence of dolphins. You are breaking the speed limit, flying at Mach 1.5.
Don't you have your faster, right?
There's no need to print the wind farmers here, Odin. We're all here for the same reason, because we have a problem. Murder! I'm ready to start the 12-step process!
The 12-step process has actually been decreased to a single step due to the fact that we felt 12 was overkill and due to budget cuts. There's only one step, though. Don't eat this.
But dolphins are fish! What's wrong with you guys? Is there a ghost lake in here?
I know me a little mom and pop business that works with petroleum products, but now wants to branch out in a way to help the healing process for these poor, unfortunate souls. That little business is called Halliburton, and they have just released Snarling Chingy's Artificial Salmon. It's a great way to kick that dang fish habit. Snarling Chingy's Artificial Salmon
made with real dolphin and some tuna.
You blinked, I could tell. We have triumphed in this battle of wills. Am I not correct in this assumption?
We won!
No, I did not.
What are you going to do? Disintegrate us? We must leave, for we are far too advanced for this crude behavior. Shoot profanities as we run in terror.
Oh man, the resolution on this thing is phenomenal.
You got the lens cap on here, sir?
Yes, this morning, the carcass of this creature was found washed up on the Pacific shore. Units from the Japanese Self-Defense Force are working tirelessly to boil a pot large enough to cook the creature and serve it as medicinal cure for the Italian flu.
You'll have to clear the area, sir.
But I have to finish.
Oh, you'll finish? Over Kamebis' dead body. I just thought of that one. Or is it Kamebis? I don't know.
Take a good look. This is what we're up against. What's even worse is that some monsters are even bigger than this. It was wounded, it seems, and managed to reach the coast. Thank you, Captain Obvious. You're welcome, Major Sarcasm. And it's a big one, too. First one we've seen since 1901 in several score years, give or take a fortnight.
Now that's a Kamebis, right?
Doi! Yes, it was found on Selgio Island, discovered by Dr. Mia and his band of dashing, roguish scientists. They called themselves the Gezora Brigade. Ganymede had once again fell short of gaining any fleeting iota of fan favoritism, but he got his revenge. He used the Cruciatus Curse against the giant condor until he divulged the location of the red bamboos hidden. Is this story going somewhere? It is. What I was trying to get at was the creature's scientific name. Megalomatamata, which is somewhat difficult to say in any language, except French. And what about his injury? What? Oh, there's no injury. I'm sorry I was mistaken. It's all psychosomatic. He's faking. But I can only surmise that such unusual behavior was caused due to his studies of dirtopsychology at Harvard, and I can only assume that his professor was some kind of giant predator.
Like another monster, sir.
Yes. It can only be Godzilla. Niles D. Godzilla, Esquire, Professor of Reptilian Psychology. He just got tenure last year.
Last week there was one Easter egg and now there are two Easter eggs. I hope you're happy. Goodbye.
Maybe if we lock you up, you'll stop using your creepy otherworldly powers to awaken giant monsters.
One would think so, wouldn't one?
You can leave now. I can leave now.
Okay, now I gotta wake up Barrakhan. Worked. Don't backsass me. Now. Get Godzilla! I would have been better off with Varen.
Kong. Kong, Kongaroo, Hong Kong Donkey, Kongarama, Rama, Ding Dong, Kong, Ping Pong, Kong, So Long, Rong Kong, Kikidi, Kikidi, Kong, Kong. Kong!
Fact! Susan Watson says some variation of Kong 186,282 times during the film King Kong Escapes. It's true!
Hey, you guys want to see my butt?
Not particularly.
Well, that's too bad, isn't it?
5 hours later.
That's easily the most hideous thing I've ever seen. It's absolutely disgusting.
Can't disagree with you there.
What? Am I missing something?
Dude, I would have rather seen his butt than that.
Ditto.
It's not my fault! It's Barragans or something.
Senseless behavior. Our belligerent attitudes towards each other are misplaced, especially considering the glaring fact that we both face a common foe.
Yes, indeed. Quiet. From henceforth, let us do the Mitosaka, not as a byproduct of our violence towards one another, but instead as a combined effort in our never-ending quest to annihilate humankind.
And so, Godzilla and Anguilla teamed up to destroy you, the humans, so long.
The world's major cities, townships, villages, burgs, and stinkholes are being invaded one by one by the monsters. Moscow by Rodan, Beijing by Mothra, and London by Manda. Paris by Barragan.
What?!
Hartford, Connecticut by the Matango. Front Royal, Virginia by Majin Tool. Jersey City by Donald Trump's hair. And Jacksonville, Florida by the Florida Skunk Ape. Oh, here's a special news bulletin. Godzilla is now in Newkirk City. This city has been invaded by Godzilla.
Clearly, this invasion is simply a misunderstanding, for I have altered my sinister ways. I mean no ill will toward the people of Newkirk. I merely desire a day to enjoy the wonderful stench of your fair Middleburg.
Well said! Let us bad dig, shall we?
Let's.
St. Louis! By governor! Yeah, I know it's lame.
Zalatanosaurus! What's wrong? What's the matter? Don't let him bully you around like that! Come on now, get up! Get up! Protect them! Yes, protect my secret! Protect my secret from the world! Protect the secret of my 11 herbs and spices!
Father continuously attempts to conceal the identity of his 11 herbs and spices. By reverse engineering, mass marketable foodstuffs is perfectly legal. I'm sure his secret has already been revealed. The fool! He doesn't realize that the future lies in extra crispy!
I don't care if she's an evil android bent on the destruction of humankind. I love her. I love her so much. Her metallic sheen. Her emotionless face. The diesel exhaust fumes. Oh, where can I begin?
I think that Mechagodzilla and Titanosaurus are winning. Godzilla has defeated numerous foes of varying strengths plenty of times in the past. What makes him think he can do it again?
Sir, your UFO is getting towed.
Where's my disintegrator? I've had enough of those people.
Her numerous serial ports, her gears and cogs. Oh my, how could I forget that scrumptious nuclear core?
Excuse me, Mr. Clicker. I began adding Easter eggs with the release of my third tune, Expired Mech. I'm not going to go and sully this artifact of a tune with some cheap, unnecessary extra, okay? So there. But to be honest, I only began adding those curvy edges around the frame with my fifth tune, a snake-like thing on a plane. So, yeah, I guess me talking also defeats the no Easter egg thing, too. Oh boy. I'm fairly certain I just wasted a great deal of your time. I'm very sorry.
Yeah, you should be, you little jerk!
And so do I.
And so do I.
And so do I. Me too.
What's that?
A huge meteor is going to hit the Earth in 1999? For the 1,000th time, yes! Bacchero was going to stop the asteroid before it hit Earth, but because of the careless pollution that you humans create, that other asteroid hit first, which caused Bacchero to be defeated by Godzilla.
I'm not exactly sure how you're connecting the dots there.
It's quite simple. You are all jerks, and we don't like you.
Surely you can't hate all of us.
We like the little girl, but that is about it.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome, you polite little girl. I'm surprised that piece of over there could have possibly spawned you.
Now wait just a second.
What can we do about this new threat?
You can either A. wet your pants like a bunch of sissies, B. let Mothra do your dirty work for you, or C. send your 200 megaton hydrogen bomb to divert the asteroid's course.
So you have no problem with us choosing B, right? I mean, you wouldn't have given us that option otherwise, right?
We are watching you!
There! Right there! That's where our story begins! In the dark tower of Gabardura, in the lands of mist, in the deepest, darkest reaches of villain land. But enough about that! Here, within the confines of Gabardura's wintered residence in Titus, Florida.
Yes! I think I will steal Christmas this year. So many people have attempted to do so in the past, but I'm sure I will succeed, and if not, we'll all learn some big mushy lesson in the process. And now here I go. I'm really not animated very well, am I?
Aww.
Give me all of your candy canes, and your horn swagglers, and your doodad something or others, and your, socks. Maybe your shoes, too.
Yes, another jerk trying to steal Christmas! This will be so great and it's great, so happening! And this year, to whom should I pay my respects?
Why, to jolly old Santa Claus, of course! That's me!
Santa! You continually attempt to steal Christmas, and yet you are well aware that I, Deuterius, have stopped you on occasions plenty!
Why did you do that?
Do what?
Why did you put the adjective after the noun? That was very weird!
It has an old tiny flair!
I think it's just stupid!
Well, I think Santa is an anagram for...
Satin! Look at those satin curtains! Why don't you just give me all of your worldly possessions now? That would be lovely!
You and your elven friends bastardize the true meaning of Christmas!
Alright, enough
grab my sweater vest! I'll be there in a second. A dog! The house is empty! But for some reason, I don't want to loot his home. Perhaps this indeed is the Christmas spirit, not wanting to loot homes.
Let's begin this tale, shall we? We start off with Godzilla Baggins' birthday. He just turned 111, which is a huge, enormous number by any stretch of the imagination. Our old friend, Varin the Grey, has just arrived. Looks like he brought some fireworks with him. He's always prepared for a party. But all is not as it seems. Godzilla just made himself vanish at the birthday party. Monsters are way too dumb to notice obvious trap doors and makeshift platforms. Varin the Grey confronts Godzilla. Uh-oh, Godzilla, you've got some splaining to do. Looks like old Goji's got some wanderlust. Better take me old oxygen destroyer with me, he says. Varin rebukes him.
There are many oxygen destroyers in the world, and none of them should be used so lightly.
Godzilla retorts.
You'll have to pry it from me cold dead hands.
Godzilla is a member of the NRA, by the way, and has several unrelated financial connections with the Bush administration. Varin luckily manages to pry the oxygen destroyer from Godzilla's cold, dead hands.
He's dead, folks.
Looks like young Minya Baggins just got home. Stepping over Godzilla's lifeless body, he finds the old wizard Varin in a state of deep funking. Varin leaves the oxygen destroyer with Minya. Varin likes to be reckless. Varin leaves for the Cell Tower of Risengard. Monster X, the head of the Wizarding Order, greets Varin with a sly grin. He'll be the first to die, thinks Monster X. Monster X likes to show off his Palantir. He won it in a sweepstakes. Monster X's gaze has led him to the dark land of Al Gordor in the east. He is now the dark servant of the dark kingdom bathed in darkness under the control of the dark villain of darkness, ness, 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 dark, dark, dark. Destroyer! He looks cool, but he's bad and quite dark in nature. Doom. Monster X decides to trap Varin on top of the Cell Tower of Risengard, cause he's just that kind of guy. Meanwhile, Minya Baggins has grown worried. Minya decides, on a whim, to take the oxygen destroyer to Mount Boom in Al Gordor in order to destroy the fell evil once and for all. He just has a gut feeling, is all. Four companions randomly decide to join him on the way. Their names are Rodan Took, Beragon Brendibuck, Anguirus Gamgee, and Hugh Hefner. Hugh becomes distracted along the way. And the four remaining companions ignore the Old Forest and Tom Bombadil as they make their approach to the cheesy town of Bree. And that's where we end our story for now.
Aww.
Oh, what the heck. Let's cut ahead to the ending for a second. Continue our tale of the weird and often frightening realm of Monster Earth, shall we? As Beragon Brandybuck and Rodan Took approached Bree, horrible servants of the enemy carried them away and abandoned them in Dangdarn Forest, for no apparent reason. There, they were befriended by Biolante, and she offered to take them to Risengard. She decided it was about time to destroy Monster X's tower. After all, she was an AT&T customer anyway. And so they toppled the Citadel, and Varin flew to warn the others of the increasing power of Destoroyah, who, by the way, is this story's version of Sauron, if you haven't guessed that already, although he's not in glowing eye form. That's more like the book, anyway. Yeah. Meanwhile, nine dark riders of fell virtue and horrible hygiene were released atop evil shrimp named Abira to reclaim the oxygen destroyer for its true master, Destoroyah. They were arrested in Georgia, however, for quote-unquote broken taillights. Elsewhere, Minya and Anguirus Gamgee had already left Bree with a complete stranger who called himself Titanosaurus. The stranger. It's good to trust strangers. They ventured into the realm of Riverbell. Betrond, the half-Marthin, was the leader of the fair race of the moths.
"Don't bring any bright lights into my realm," said Betrond.
Verin reunited with his friends, and Moth Regulus and Orr Gibley joined their party. Their HP was nearly quadrupled in the process, and each one rose to level 40. Minya received a space titanium coat. After they left Riverbell, Verin fell into shadow after fighting the demonic aggregate on the bridge of Khazar's doom.
"Arr!"
he yelled as he fell. Verin ate quite a lot, so nobody cared. Then they came to the beautiful forest of Mothmorien and burned it completely to the ground, so nobody would dare follow them. Then Zilla appeared. He used to bear the Oxygen Destroyer before Godzilla Baggins won it decades earlier in a riddle match. Riddle matches are binding contracts in Monster Earth.
"Fluffy bastards, nothing hurts the precious,"
Zilla said. Everyone threw Zilla into a pit for safekeeping. He screamed. Meanwhile, Destoroyah woke up from a NyQuil-induced coma and realized how far he'd accidentally let the Fellowship come. He said with a grimace. So he bailed out his favorite Dark Rider, Bagin, the Witch King of Khazar-nit, and sent him on a dark mission. But that's a story for another day.
Aww.
You suck.
Oh, what the heck. Let's return to the beginning, shall we?
Oh, come on!
Alright, let's end this tale, shall we? Finally. And so everybody fell into a wormhole. And by sheer chance, they ended up at the Cracks of Boom in Mount Boom. Everyone, except Godzilla and Verin, who weren't there because they're dead or something, yelled to Minya to throw the Oxygen Destroyer into the lava.
"Don't rush me,"
he yelled. Then an idea struck Minya.
"If I claim it as my own, I can use it to destroy Destoroyah,"
he said maniacally. And so he did. Little did anyone realize that the Oxygen Destroyer could be used only but once. Common sense is often lost on the senseless. Minya was sad, because he really liked the Oxygen Destroyer. It made him feel powerful. After all, it was most precious to him. Oh well. And so they all return to their respective homes in Monster Earth. I'm going to keep the map up for a while so you can see some stuff. But when Minya returned to his home in the Mire, all was not as it seemed. Monster X had scoured it. So they went back through time using another wormhole, and they made the cell tower of Isengard fall on Monster X, trapping him once and for all. At least, for now. When they came back to the present, all was well. And Zilla was released from his pit and came to live in the Mire with the monsters. He was quoted as saying,
"We want some kisses."
By the way, Godzilla Baggins and Verin the Grey are just fine. They've been hiding behind that bush the whole time. And the Dark Rider Bagin, whom we ended the last story on, rides a beer to the unemployment office. And that ends our story. For good.
Finally.
And here's an illustration of a kitty.
there is a great storm coming. Monster Island, why don't you prepare for your impending doom? You sit there as though you know everything, but you know what? There are some things that you do not know, so I will therefore take that to my advantage and hurt you all. Through means of a supernatural nature, although some of my means may be quite natural. For example, poison tends to be natural, but oh, let's say super poison tends to be unnatural. Supernatural, if you will. You all fear me now, for I am Monster X, and the X stands for extreme. Oh, that was lame. As I sat there in my cave of doom and wonder, I thought of the many ways I would get my revenge on the Monster Islanders. But there were too many ways to think of, because my brain is so big. Nevertheless, I would come up with something almost inconsiderately bad in store for you. I can see by the look in your faces, which I can see telepathically because they go into my brain and I can tell what they're doing, your faces that is, that you doubt my power and have yet to heed my warnings and pay me my due. 50,000 Hershey's bars in the latest issue of Mad Magazine. But I shall soon prove that you are weak. Weak like weird... Weakity-weaks are! Therefore, I must blow up something to show you that I am serious. This is your final warning! I'm about to blow something up seriously. Hold on a second. Oh! Did you feel the vibration? Something just blew up, I think. I think it was some kind of bridge or something here. Let me check. It's something important, that you can't live without. Let's see, possibly the water supply. I blew up the water supply, so there you have 24 hours to comply with whatever my demands were. So I'm thinking to myself, hey, I just blew up the friggin' water supply! Surely they're going to hand over my ransom and pay me my dues, which was the ransom. But nay, nay, you have yet to do anything! You have done nothing! Even though I've devoted so much time to trying to do something! It's like you don't even care! I need a smoothie.
So, the Cargo Department is where you're going to be working. I hope you enjoy your employment at Beast Buy.
Yeah, yeah, whatever. So who's my direct manager?
Well, I am. If you have any problems whatsoever, feel free to find me in the break room. I'll be playing Call of Duty with the other supervisors.
Level with me, will you? How likely am I to get a promotion?
Good question. How well do you kiss butt?
Fairly well.
You'll do fine, then. Who knows? Someday you might become department senior yourself.
And what does that job entail?
50% pay raise and a 500% increase in duties.
What about a management position?
$50 pay raise and a 500% decrease in duties. Now you don't get too far ahead of yourself. Your nose isn't quite brown enough yet. Oh, look at the time. It's 9:47 a.m. Time for my first break.
All right. I've already been fired from the supermarket for eating that old lady. But she deserved it. And I've also been fired from Sears Hardware for indecent exposure. Surely I can manage to retain this position. Ah, my first customer!
Hello, mindless little drone! I'm looking for a camera!
All right, what do are you about battery life and picture quality?
Listen, wait, Slade! I just want a camera, a car of my own! Do you have a red one?
Why on earth would the color matter?
Red things are always better! I want a red one!
Alright! We have a nice red Sony camera! The WV55. The most recent and shiny red camera technology!
What about the Shadio F880? This is a much better shade of red!
Believe me, you don't want it!
Why not?
Because when you take a picture with the Sony, it looks like a photograph! But when you take a picture with the Shashio, it looks like congealed doggy vomit!
But the Sony is $5 more! You don't expect me to actually be bamboozled by your bamboozlery!
Sir, I don't make a commission! It doesn't make a bleeding difference to me! In fact, if you suddenly decided to beat yourself senseless with one of these cameras, I would be more than elated!
Don't be normal, but I think I'll take the Shashio!
Alright, can I interest you in a memory card?
What? In the name of the aliens from the third planet from the black hole, it's a memory card!
The camera can only hold about 7 bloody pictures in its internal memory. A memory card would allow you to hold hundreds!
Even though you yourself do not control the fact that the manufacturers have decided to build and launch the cameras in such a way, and even though you don't take commission of the bottom and give me a memory card, even though you're contractually obligated not to, I summon all the powers of figures of maidenness to arm you like the god you are for appearing such a fantasy upon my innocent consumer ears!
Are you quite done?
Yes!
Alright, did you need a carrying case for your camera?
I want to speak to a manager!
Can I have a manager over to the camera department, please?
3 hours later.
Oh, sorry about that, sir. I just got off my first break. How can I help you?
This, quote-unquote, gentleman has had me waiting for literally 1,100 hours!
Well, I can't control how friggin' long it takes for a manager to get here, you know.
Nevertheless, I want you to throw in a carrying case and a memory card for free with my camera purchase.
Well, I'm not sure why our new employee would have given you the slightest notion that we even do that.
I didn't! He didn't even tell me why he needed you!
But we do not negotiate prices.
Well, then, maybe I'll just go to a physical retailer in a 30-mile radius and complain about my $270 count down to my outrageous demands!
All right, we'll take 2% off the memory card, but just this once.
Alright, so let's go over the stipulations of the four-way alien alliance once more. Nebulans, a small parcel of land will be bordered off in France to make room for Euro children's land.
Agreed!
Aliens from the third planet from the black hole will receive a much shorter name. We will hack off all unnecessary words and letters, and they will be from henceforth known as the Ackholes.
We did not agree to that.
The Kelox will receive a super hot sauna. Super hot sauna for super hot ladies.
You are not fooling anyone, Controller.
Finally, the people of Planet X will require a field of daffodils.
There will be no elaboration as to our need for daffodils, nor why it is so urgent, but rest assured, we will surely perish without our field of daffodils. Moving on. Hello, what have we here? Apparently there are stipulations for the Alliance in regards to a fifth alien race, which seem to have been in the form of an addendum, rendered completely in crayon.
Psst, crayon is for little babies. Isn't that right,
Yeah, that's colored pencil!
According to this, you desire dozens of pizzas and all the Rambo movies on DVD. Those kind of demands led us to cast away the Mysterians, you know.
And what did the Mysterians request?
All that they wrote was land and chicks.
We'll change ours to that one. Isn't that right,
Awesome!
I love the aliens in one place.
I don't get what you have to use this for.
Class Imperial Cruiser, two of them coming straight at us.
Sir.
Shut them up or shut them down. Or shut them high or eat a pie. A doo-doo-doo and a doo-doo-doo. Electric shields at maximum. We can't outsmart them, but we can still outdance them.
What's wrong with you?
Witterstim spice, baby. Now hold on to your cow pies.
Take a nice luncheon. Don't get too close. Hey, I can see Captain Destroyers up here.
Prepare to make the jump to hyperspace.
Oh, come on, live a little. Let's engage them at point blank range. Come on!
Sir, if I may say so,
our
hyperdrive hostile wheels are online. It's impossible to make the jump to hyperspace.
We're in trouble.
That's a good boy. You're better to get back on the wheel. Daddy wants to live to see tomorrow.
That wasn't a laser thingy.
Time clearance! Get up here! Asteroids.
Santa Barbara, keep her steady. They'd be cuckoo banana brains to follow us, wouldn't they?
Sir, the odds are
successfully
coming.
Asteroid 3721. Oh. Those are kind of bad odds. Maybe we should...
Oh, grow up, Pear. Keep her steady, Santa.
Meanwhile, on the distant planet of Dagora.
Your Dagora, I welcome you. Yes. Chief experts of Dagora, you will find, consist of Jedi Knights, Feigned Mischief, and Object Subject Verb Sentence Construction.
Something's burning. Did you let one?
It's too radioactive, huh?
You always carry a Geiger counter with you wherever you go.
Listen, you.
I've been through 2 Godzilla attacks, 1 Angolus assault, a Rodan raid, and I've eaten at an A&W.
Wow.
So I'm fairly certain I know when to bring a Geiger counter with me. Wait, what's that coming out of the hillside? Is it a present? Is it a present for all of us?
Beep, 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 beep. Hello, fellas. I am here to invade you. Yes. Beep, 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 beep. I want my mama.
This isn't what it looks like.
Take that! And that! Why aren't you succumbing to my terrible onslaught?
Beep, 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 beep.
Fellas, your gunshots feel like bees. If bees were deprived of their stingers and left with a salt stick from a stylus on their abdomen instead.
Beep, 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 beep.
Now it's trash talking us.
There's only one thing we can do. Shoot some more.
Miss Biolante, is it? I understand you're in politics.
Yeah, I'm a member of the Alliance.
You're not one of those bleeding heart rebels, are you?
You're not one of those Limbaugh-quoting Imperials, are you?
Touché. Well, this evening is still salvageable if we get some...
Darn.
...service over here.
Hey, look, there's a kid behind you.
Just ignore him.
Hi, mister. What's your name?
Gavra.
My name is a giant condor.
That's a stupid name.
I was 2.5 years
old. Oh, nice.
I never show with Yu-Gi-Oh!
Oh, awful.
Sometimes I wish I were Yu-Gi-Oh! Then I could fight crime.
That's not what Yu-Gi-Oh!
Sometimes if I concentrate real hard,
yeah.
I poop my pants.
That was unnecessary.
Do you want to hear any nursery words?
I got some limericks.
I know a few. Want to hear?
Categorically.
Mary had a little lamb. E-I-E-I-O! And when she sold some of it, well, that's my name, Bingo! Wasn't that cool?
Terrible.
Why are you so ugly?
Because when I was in school, I pushed a kid too far, and he unleashed a screaming, horrible beam upon my delectable facade. This is what I look like after the reconstructive surgery.
My mom told me not to tell people that she got plastic surgery for her.
Hello. I'm like... gonna be your waiter tonight. My name is Black Moth.
That's an
Can I, take your orders?
Where's my dinner? I ordered 2 old ladies on rye a half hour ago.
Oh, I'll have to ask my manager.
Ask him what?
Tonight's special is 2 old ladies on rye. Poo.
Oh, so this is where I find you. You told me you were staying at your brother's.
No, I'm pretty sure I told you I was going out with Gavra.
Lies? Too many lies? What do you suppose I'm going to have to tell Jaina and Jason?
Who?
Oh, just pretend to forget our imaginary children that I made up. Go on, just pretend.
Didn't I just see Kirby and Meta Knight outside the window? Seriously, am I crazy?
I'll be home in a few minutes. Not like this is going anywhere.
Yeah, you could say that again.
Well then, maybe I'll just wait outside.
Yeah, you do that.
Excuse me? Hello? Let me get through.
Waiter, I would desire a word with you. I seem to have discovered a rather large fish rodent in my soup.
I sneeze! It's the chaos! Hey, I think I remember you from somewhere. Do you know Dr. Shiragami? No, Thomas!
This is my lord, this old Imperial Covenant brother!
Keep your temper under wraps, Rodan. You know what they said? They're gonna put you in anger management if you're not careful!
Seriously! I don't know what you're saying half the time! I'll see you, little puke!
head is unfit for consumption. I've got to warn the people. I've got to forget everything I've seen here today, man.
All around the raspberry bush, the monkey chased the weasel. The weasel thought was all fun. Pop goes the weasel.
Kirby, your skills are impressive.
Yeah, but Nidoking yourself.
True warriors do not say Nidoking.
But I just did.
And so, Miles continued to add one Easter egg after another, until his tune got so old and dry that McDonald's could have served it as a breakfast sandwich. The Mick give it a rest already. That is all.
Hey, you! What the heck are ya?
I am a Martian. I'm an old lady, you little weirdo! Yeah! What do you think I am? What are you? Who am I?
I am a scary fire demon from Brooklyn.
Yeah! You don't look like a demon! You look more like a Tamagotchi! I'm gonna raise you, little Tamagotchi, and then I'll use you to fight other people with Tamagotchis.
That's not what you do with Tamagotchis.
Yes, it is. You corner somebody in a back alley who's got a Tamagotchi, then you beat them up with your Tamagotchi. And when they turn in, you play the sweet little innocent old wagey act, and then the person who got beat up gets 30 days hard labor.
Boy, that's kinda rough.
Ha! You should see how I play with my Pokemon. Are you a Pokemon? You look like the thing on Charmander's tail.
Well, actually...
Wait a sec! You're the Will-O-The-Wisp attack that my Miss Magius misfired. And you've come to life to give me a warning about the future. Tell me, little Will-O-The-Wisp, will I ever get married?
Though I can't really see the future, I can pretty much guarantee we both know the answer to that question.
Hot dog! I'm gonna be all over Brad Pitt like an old cougar on a dumb bunny. You watch out, Angelina Jolie. Soon you're gonna be Angelina Alone Jolie. Alone Jolina. She's gonna be alone, okay?
That was more information than I needed to hear. Listen, I can tell that somebody put a pretty nasty spell on you. Possibly an angry relative. Possibly a disgruntled mailman. Or quite possibly the Wicked Witch of the Waste.
That's right. I was a young girl once. That was about 80 years ago.
Are you saying you just grew old with time?
It's a slow-working spell.
All right. How about if I make a deal with you? You find some way to free me from this bond I have with Howl, and I'll reverse your spell. I've got plenty of Neutrogena and Botox in the back. No guarantees, of course.
Why? What's with you and Howl? You guys married or something? You looking to get out of that?
What? No, 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 no. All right, listen, sweetie, I've got stuff to do. If you'd like, I can make you some hot chocolate.
Thanks, but all I need right now is some hot Brad Pitt. Hoo yeah! Hoo doggy!
I think I'm gonna be sick. Hey, you. Chris Merja Hangier. Merja Gajanger. Chris Merja. Yeah. What's Project G?
I'm not telling.
Come on. Just a little hint.
No, I don't think so.
Come on.
No.
I'll be your friend.
Well, okay. Project G is basically.
My name is Kitaya!
This is the part where I'm supposed to clap! Well, howdy do!
It's good to be here, dude. Dude, I think you're mistaking me for Amanda. Oh, don't worry, it's a common error. Again, dude, that's, Amanda.
No! I'm saying
Dude, Manda and I are two completely different kaiju. For one, he has stubby little limbs. And do I look like I have stubby little limbs?
Did somebody order the old lady takeout special? Oh, I'm like so not trained for this. Oh.
Dude, this is clearly not King Caesar. This is Black Moth, a kaiju featured in Latitude Zero.
I think you're a gummy dumb dumb brain, Deuteleos! Did you see that? I just zinged him.
Oh, that was such an intelligent quip, my dear sir. Might I ask what happened to the eloquent and articulate gabbler that appeared in the Dune the Stand 2?
You're no fun.
At least I look like the monster I'm supposed to represent.
Okay, now you're just asking for it.
Why, no, why, they are not Manda.
Okay, you're not Manda.
Pit to it.
You know, sometimes people mistook me for Godzilla.
Oh, really? Hey, Wolfen, how's that happened?
Words.
Sometimes people mistake me for Tony Blair. Hey, really?
Sigh. I wish I had some form of iconic hero to look up to.
Wiggity wiggity ballaroonies!
It's Gabra Jordan, everybody's favorite basketball player.
Yeah, yeah, shut up, kid.
If you little different wanna be as wonderfully wonderful as Gabra Jordan, then there's only one thing you need. Shoes that pump up when you squeeze them. Squeezy, 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 kaboom!
Wow, that's some sure and made magical trick there. Why don't you come over here and teach me some of your voodoo?
Yeah, yeah, shut up, kid. I've had enough of you.
Don't think I don't remember Tune 44.
What?
Never mind! Any dang way! Watch! As Gabra Jordan, for the first time on television, makes the coolest freaking free throw on planet Earth! Huzzah! Did you see that? I went right over the net! I never got that high before.
Anyway, next question. Who do you look up to?
Me!
Next question. On a scale of 1 to 5, how great do you think you are?
Well, that's a good question! What's the highest number?
I don't think there is a highest number.
77!
No, it's not.
Caution! If you don't wish to subject yourself to mind-blowing spoilers, please stick your fingers in your ears and yell, "La la la la, I can't hear you!" while closing your eyes during the course of this cartoon. Thank you.
Hello! We're the Kaiju Critics! Spelled with 2 K's because it's funny!
It really isn't.
It was his idea.
Anywho, we're going to critique both! It's a movie about a dog who thinks that he's a person! The dog thinks he's people! No, that's wrong! The dog thinks he has superpowers!
And he does!
No, he doesn't! Anyway, he meets a cat along the way.
The cat's name is Chester! Chester Cheetah! This cheese-loving feline introduces our plucky protagonist to the wonderful world of pseudo-snacks and advanced cross-marketing stratagems.
Are you quite done?
After that, the dog and the cat meet the hamster.
Yes, and the hamster turns out to be
Hamtaro! The hamster is Hamtaro! What? What? It's true, isn't it?
Absolutely not! Anyway, the dog, the cat, and the blinking hamster go off on an adventure to save Colonel Sanders from the clutches of Dave Thomas, founder of Wendy's.
Dave Thomas is an evil robot in this movie.
Did you even watch the film?
I got the gist of it from a poster! I'll grant you it was a Photoshop fan poster on DeviantArt, but that doesn't make it any less valid!
Yes, yes, it does make it less valid! It's invalid. You're invalid. Anywho, I rated 4 score and 7 bones out of a possible baker's dozen squared.
I rate this movie 4 picnic baskets out of a possible 7.
Thank you for watching today's 2 Toho Monsters Critique a Non-Toho Movie. Good night!
And don't forget, 4 out of 5 doctors are intoxicated while they perform routine procedures. Thank you!
Hello! We're the Kaiju Critics, spelled with 2 K's because... This week we're going to review Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince. This is what we would be saying if they hadn't pushed back the friggin' release date! It was supposed to come out last month! They made me cry! And to make matters worse, take a gander at this trailer that was still playing even after they announced that the release date was going to be rescheduled. We're being told that we can't use the real trailer, so here's our own version.
Let's look in the pensive, shall we, Harry?
Oh, gee, gosh, golly, gee, why don't we, Headmaster Dumbledore?
So, your name is Tom Riddle, is it? Tell me about yourself.
I like to do horrible things to people. Teach me how to be a wizard, Mr. Dumbledore!
You'll be my greatest pupil, Tom Riddle!
Call me Voldemort!
No problemo! Let's get you fitted for an effeminate British dress gown!
Yay!
Did you know, Headmaster? Did you?
What? Did I know that that little tyke would grow up to be the evilest, most diabolical, and just all-around plain worst jerk of a wizard to ever become a power-hungry would-be dictator? Yes. Yes, I did. And I'd do it again, too, in a heartbeat.
Look! Looky there! It still says November!
So wrong, so false, and yet so frustratingly suspenseful.
Anyway, I rate this movie a square root of -1 out of a Googleplex, because it isn't out yet! It's supposed to be out yet!
I rate this movie 1 Petrificus out of 3 Totalises.
Thank you for watching today's episode of 2 Toho Monsters Review a Non-Toho Movie. Good night! And remember, don't pick at it!
It just might explode.
Oh no! I think I'm about to sneeze! Ah,
crap, you just killed Godzilla.
Live from City Monster Island in the South Pacific, it's the 3rd annual Toho Season Christmas Special. And now, your host, Violante and Italia.
Welcome to the 3rd annual Toho Kingdom Christmas Special 3. Tonight we're going to be showing you yet another sickening secular pseudo Christmas special.
Boo, 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 boo. Good news, everybody. The tape with the sickening secular pseudo Christmas special burned up in a fire, ignited by a match. And some gasoline! And my rage!
Yay!
And so tonight we're going to be presenting you yet another episode of 2 Toho Monsters Review a Non-Toho Movie. Boo! Boo! Boo!
Correct. Boo! To an untold degree.
Boo! Boo!
Hey!
Hello! We're the Kaiju Critics! Spelled with Connor! Anyway, we're going to review this year's remake of The Day the Earth Stood Still.
Starring Neo!
Most excellent.
Get out of here! Anyway, this film was okay. Not great, just okay.
It was fine! No complaints, really.
But still, we both know that you're all thinking, hey, how could those two dashing young kaiju have made the film better?
Me and that girl. Are they really?
Yeah.
Silencio!
See?
Well, in answer to your unspoken question of doom and wonder, here's our answer in annoying cutaway form.
I am going to ask you a series of control questions. Are you single?
No.
Is your voice a mediocre parody of a villainous character from SpongeBob SquarePants?
It's time for my highly elaborate and college-educated answer. No!
Are you aware of an impending attack on planet Earth?
You should let me go now.
I will repeat the question.
Seriously, I've been telling you for about a half hour. I have to use the friggin' can! I just traveled 14 light years without peeing! Honestly!
Ah!
That's how I would have done the movie. Just replace Keanu Reeves with me. It's gold! It's better than gold! It's platinum!
What about palladium?
That's much worse! That's only like $200 an ounce! Also, we could have done without that annoying kid character.
Can I kill you?
No.
I think I should kill you. My dad would have killed you.
Oh, would you just shut your freaking head?
Here's how I would have done the movie.
So, your idea is to have the Earth actually stand still.
Well, of course! With a title like The Day the Earth Stood Still, you expect the Earth to stand still! I haven't been this disappointed since I saw 12 Monkeys. There weren't any monkeys! Well, unless you count Brad Pitt.
At any rate, our time is up. I rate this movie a pi out of a possible pi r squared.
I rate this movie a 7 out of 10. What? Aren't I allowed to do a real rating once in a while?
Thank you for watching today's episode of Two Toho Monsters Review a Non-Toho Movie. Good night.
And don't forget, I'm better than you.
Silence!
Next question. Are you wearing boxers or briefs?
Boxers. I mean briefs. All right. Bikini underwear. G-string. Hello! We're the kaiju critics, spelled with two K's because yada 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 yada.
Hey!
Today we're going to review the curious case of Benjamin Button. Talk about a flick that rips your heart right out of your chest.
And grinds it into hot dog meat and serves it at the school cafeteria. As mashed potatoes!
I could have made this movie so much less mind-numbingly depressing. Behold! The curious case of Benjamin Barragon. Oh no, I'm an old man. Oh wait, now I'm a young man. Oh wait, now I'm a baby. Goo goo goo.
Hey! That's just like that other movie you made me see! 2001, A Space Iliad.
Odyssey! And the trippy scene with the guy who keeps changing ages actually harkens more to the sequel that nobody ever talks about with that guy from Jaws. 2010, the year we made contact.
Get out of the water! Get out of the water!
What was the point of that?
9 out of 10! Benjamin Button is a must-see! Thanks for watching us! Good night!
Gah! Let's read some fan mail, shall we? Billy H. from somewhere writes about Jurassic Park 4.
They changed the freaking release date. It was supposed to come out in 2004. Then they changed it to 2005 and 2006 and 2007 until it became a chicken run for its release date.
Honestly!
Does chicken run even work in that sentence?
Dinosaurs with guns. But cheer up!
There are many things more important in this world than the prospect of 5 raptors of the Deinonychus genus packing heat! I really can't think of a whole lot of them right now, because the sweet thought of dinos with guns just won't leave my brain! If you want Monster X to read your borderline psychotic thoughts and briefly acknowledge your existence in a future cartoon, please email Monster X at monster_x04@yahoo.com.
offer valid while supplies last. I'm a supply!
Hello! We're the kaiju critics!
What? Nothing? Oh, well.
Anyway, we really didn't see any new movies worth mentioning, so we're going to review some Godzilla movies today.
No! I want to review The Many Adventures of Winnie the Pooh!
Well, I don't!
Well, how about a compromise? Behold.
Mail time! Angel R. from Parts Unknown speaks of Godzilla Final Wars.
Hello! My name is Angel. I love Monster X and DFW, but why can't you turn into your Kaiser Ghidorah form and kill the wretched ugly know-it-all Gabra next to you, so he can shut up for once?
What? Kill me? He would never do anything like that. And you even think that he would count out your outrageous demands? It's laughable. And furthermore, how can you possibly call me ugly?
I'm beautiful. That bluish green freak thinks he can steal the spotlight, constantly sitting there, never really moving his arms, always pointing at nothing.
Perhaps I will turn into Kaiser
Ghidorah. Therefore, in conclusion, I have no idea if Britney Spears would really date me. Although it really would be her loss if she didn't.
On second thought, maybe you're not that much of a threat to my awesomeness. After all, your faults make me look better.
Thanks, I think.
Keep those emails coming. Magma out.
Hello, we're the Kaiju Critics!
Double K Madness! This week we're going to review Valkyrie! Watch and observe!
Redundant. I must warn you, no one ever escapes from Paddock 13, Sergeant!
Your rule, Herr Commandant!
Hey, Sarge!
Your rule, Herr Colonel!
He's a POW, don't salute him!
Ich liebe Kitty Holmes! Ich liebe Kitty Holmes!
You appear to be describing an episode of Hogan's Heroes.
You didn't watch Valkyrie, did you?
No.
Well, neither did I. Well, I hear it's pretty good. Fan mail! A green xenomorph runner from 2099, seriously, that's how he signed his email, writes about the Asylum Film Company.
Yeah. Dear Gabra and Monster X, with the Asylum dipping off everything from High School Musical to 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, do you think they'll rip off your show? Yes, your reviews are greater than Alma Mothra. XD? Oh, wait, never mind.
Get back here! First, nothing is greater than Alma Mothra.
You got that right! Quick and tremble!
And if the Asylum did try to rip off our show, it would probably look really low quality and cheap. Kind of like this.
It looks exactly the same!
Oh, I guess we can't really lower the quality much further, can we?
Send more of those emails!
Hey, that's my job.
Hello!
Kaiju Critics, that's us! Case are funny.
Our budget is even lower than normal today, so we're going to have to treat you to a clip show. Hey, Gabby, remember that time the studio was upside down? Help! The studio is upside down!
Forsooth!
And remember that time we filed our taxes?
Earned income tax credit. Could you pass me my W-2?
Forsooth!
And remember that time that Iris kept whipping us with his tendrils?
Keep those things to yourself!
I'm honestly trying to stop, but they seem to have a mind of their own. Oh, I hope I don't get transferred to the Russian front.
Forsooth! And remember that time when we accidentally killed Deutelia? And we buried him in a shallow grave in the backyard. But then he escaped and sought his revenge. Forsooth.
I actually don't remember that one.
Neither do I!
Are you just creating one of your fanfics?
Maybe. Fanny Fat Fan Mail! Doug and Anna S. from one of the many locations on planet Earth, right?
Nothing much! I just wanted to say hi! Corian! And parentheses!
Hi, I guess.
Yeah! Hi!
Well, we've done our duty.
Forsooth!
Yay, we actually remembered to list the email address this week.
Kaiju Critics is filmed before a live studio audience,
the majority of which tested their votes to prove that 2Ks are indeed funny.
2009 has proven one thing thus far, and that's that we're better off reviewing old movies. Like Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory.
And for no apparent reason, here's a clip from Willy Deutelios and the Gravy Factory.
Welcome to the Gravy Wonderful Room! Kitty, you ugly sire! Would you care to partake?
What about the sign that says nobody is to tamper with Gravy River on this punishment of mine?
Hey, no heat! Give the gravy a taste!
You are Will or Hansel and Gerald. Your parents were Murphy and Hansel and Gerald.
No, it's a room under the room with a panic and Willy Deutelios served by a giant strap. Who wants to try? It's out!
Well, in spite of that frightening scene, I'd have to rate the original Willy Wonka an 8 out of 10.
And I rate Tim Burton's remake 3 sweetie tods out of a possible Beetlejuice. What? Did you expect some kind of cheesy graphic to accompany that innocent statement?
Thanks for watching!
And remember, there's an Easter egg hidden somewhere in this studio. Can you find it?
Found it.
Fan mail! Someone who we've only managed to identify as Lamongo has written Ziki, Boogie, Doog.
He speaks Afiative!
I thought only we spoke that. Kaki Yaki Kuchi Uchi Bibli Placey.
Levi Mimi Luki Yuki Cardigraphy.
Soko Oiki Masio.
Hey, that wasn't Afiative. That was Japanese, I think.
Gomen Nasai. Email address, right here.
Hey, my name is, Ziller. I'm the one who found the Easter egg in the last cartoon. We all had a good laugh about that, but one thing that isn't funny is altering government property to hoax a sudden zombie attack. So people, when you're going down the road and you suddenly get the urge to break the padlock on a roadside traffic sign, hack onto the onboard computer and project your borderline psychotic thoughts for the world to see, take a moment, calm down, and enjoy the refreshing taste of Sierra
generic lemon lime soft drink.
You'll soon find that your childish attention-grabbing scheme was futile, because someone else is just gonna spray-paint a billboard and completely upstage you.
P.S. Don't spray-paint a billboard. That would be a stupid idea that could land you in prison.
Anyway, stay sharp, stay fresh, and stay out of road signs. And remember, if a woman doesn't find you handsome, she can at least find you handy. Yep, I've got the egg. It's mine. My own. My precious. Oh, oops. Sorry there. Went a bit too far.
Fanboy letter! A person named Godzilla73 Rules, what was his mother thinking, writes,
Dear Kaiju Critics, I made pictures of you guys because you're so cool. Godzilla73 Rules.
Yes, yes I do.
Let's load the picture, shall we?
Oh, I can't believe he sent it as a bitmap. Oh wait, oh wait!
Oh, man, did I just see the percentage go down? How can that even happen?
Hey, Stern.
Hey, not bad. I actually look like Monster X.
And I look like Doogie Howser. Hey, what exactly am I pointing at in that picture?
What are you ever pointing at?
My best friend, you know.
You know, it's interesting that he drew fan art of fan art.
Wait, what are you saying?
Don't tell him, folks, it'd blow his mind.
Who are you talking to?
Paul Blart was quite a hilarious movie.
Hey, how come the review is just an afterthought this week?
Because the fan art was so darn awesome.
Fan art contest. Whoever could do the best fan art of Kaiju Critics will have their fan art posted in a future episode with fan art. Grand prize winners will receive accolades. Cash value equivalent to 1/20 of a cent.
You have the Ides of March.
Soothsayer, the Ides of March are come.
I see them, but not gone.
That is where you are wrong, for you see I've taken the liberty of changing every calendar in Rome. It is actually March the 16th.
You just signed your death warrant, Julius.
This is the worst adaptation of Romeo and Juliet I've ever seen!
Hey, aren't you supposed to be at work?
At what?
At work!
At who?
Chase, to get a 7!
Does that mean I have to push a button?
Yes, that means you have to push a button on the remote that is already in your hand!
Fine, but you owe me one.
Well, it appears that I'm by myself today. So, I'm gonna start reviewing mob films. Yeah, that's it. The Godfather. Absolutely hilarious. The Godfather 2. Even funnier. The Godfather 3. Not Coppola's best work, but a decent comedy nonetheless.
He's making a mockery of, something. He needs me now more than ever. I must answer the call. The call of the Kaiju Critic.
The Calzone's not here!
Screw Kaiju Critics! Give me one Calzone!
No one can resist a Calzone! Gurp! Excuse me.
But Master's a thrall. He would never turn us in for shoplifting at the Kilmore. You don't have any problems. They're all against you. And guess what? They all like Kilmart more than they like you.
Grim.
I'm not listening.
I don't care how many times I see two towers. I never get tired of this scene. I wonder what else is on.
Fan mail. Ruben, a.k.a. Tidalfire, writes...
Hi, Monster X and Gabber. I think you should make your own movie. Starring both of you!
Hey! He's talking about that movie we made!
Yes, who can ever forget our 2005 film? Gabbera X Monster X X Godzilla X Anguirus 20.
I think I might have.
Hey, Godzilla.
You suck!
You do not suck, really? I don't think so, do we? Maybe we do. I would like to apologize wholeheartedly on behalf of my friend and I if we at all gave you the impression that we suck. It was probably our fault. Sometimes our intentions may appear at face value ambiguous. But rest assured, it will not happen again.
As I recall, it was in Albania's top 20 for 2 consecutive weeks.
Again, I don't recall that.
No Easter egg for you. Don't forget the fan art contest.
Welcome to Kaiju Critics. K's and all that. This week...
Oh, you're wondering about what I'm holding.
What? I
I'm what?
Or if you must know, it's a blues harp. It may not look like a harp to the layman. That's because it's actually a harmonica. That's another name for a harmonica, a blues harp. Anyhow, I just got this French harp.
I thought you said it was a blues harp.
From Guitar Outlet in the mall. I won't bother you by playing it.
Good! Anyway, Yes Man is this week's movie. Although the last several weeks haven't featured a movie, but...
You can't play it.
What?
I don't want you to get your spit on it, so I'm sorry, you can't play it. You'll have to settle with me giving you a sample.
Okay, that's good. You can stop, please. I don't think you understand just how much I'm coming to despise your harmonica. Oh, thank goodness!
It's chromatic, not diatonic.
What does that mean?
Just wanted to tell you before I continued.
Oh, for the love of... Why am I playing straight man this week? Normally I'm the goofy one. Never the straight man. Oh, enough of this. I'm getting out the banjo. Let's see who can be more annoying. My name is Gabra. My name is Gabra. Gabra. Gabra.
Show off.
Anyway, I rate Yes Man a 2 squared out of a possible 2 cubed. Not Jim Carrey's best work. What do you think?
I think you're a showy McShowoff. And you smell funny, too. Like a tomato. Like a hearty tomato that likes to show off.
Yeah, okay.
Email. Do it. And thanks for all the emails. They're really cool.
Yeah, what are you thanking me for?
Hello. We are the Kaiju Critics. Spelled with an inordinate abundance of K's. Unfortunately, Monster X and Gabber are currently indisposed at the moment.
Meanwhile, in the dungeon underneath the studio.
I can't believe that Godzilla and Anguirus impregnated us.
Imprisoned, not impregnated. Oh, no wonder they overpowered us.
They didn't overpower us. They lured us in here with the prospect of bonbons. Oh, I still think it was worth it.
Welcome, boys, to your doom.
Well, looky here. It's that creepy skeletal turtle thing from Mothra vs. Godzilla, 1964. I am in no way creeped out right now.
Neither should you be. I was once a fleshy, non-skeletal turtle, much like yourselves.
I'm not a turtle!
But I was banished to this underrealm by the forces of ungood. Behold, I fought them valiantly with my axe, but I was smited.
Wait, are you saying you fought them off with an axe?
That is correct, but by axe, I mean golden sword of ultimate power. And by a golden sword of ultimate power, I actually mean a gun. By a gun, I actually mean guitar. And by guitar, I actually mean harmonica. By harmonica, I am referring yet again to my guitar.
How are our prisoners doing down here?
I could use some food, water, maybe, I don't know, some flesh and blood.
We already gave you those things, but you squandered them in like 3 years. You need to space it out, man.
Yeah, okay, here's the thing. I'm kind of a big deal, alright? So why don't you guys let me out, and I might consider letting you live to see tomorrow. Maybe?
You better do what he says. This dude is crazy! He made me mess my cloak.
Oh yes, I am crazy. Most definitely bonkers, man. Completely categorically certifiable. Yeah. So, how about letting me go, alright?
What do you think, Goji? Has he learned his lesson? Sure, I'm really not entirely certain who put him in here in the first place.
Yeah, you all have regret this. Yeah, you. You especially.
Me?
Yeah. You. Don't play dumb. Don't play the game with me. I don't play games, man. Yeah, that's right.
You know, we don't keep the cell door locked. You really could have just left at any time.
Are you telling me I've been here all morning for nothing?
Wait just a second. I thought he's been here for years.
Dude, pay attention. Alright, okay, I'm out of here. It's been real. Except for you, Gabra. You're toast. Alright, you're toast.
I think I just missed my crucifix. Yeah.
Hey, what about me? Hello?
Did you just hear something?
Come on, hello? Hey, someone, let me out too. Hey.
You're toast too, giant lizard. You're toast.
Aw, man.
Fan mail. Let's see here. Blah, blah, blah. Oh, you never seem to review video games. Zeke the Hedgehog.
Just to cut you off for a second, spelling kaiju critics with 2 K's is still a decent joke, right?
Anyway, let's review a game to prove him wrong, shall we? How about something new, like...
Gamera the Attention Hog 2 for the Vega Genesis.
What?
Here's a TV. And a Vega Genesis. Not to be confused with the Vega Master System. Let's play!
This appears to be a very poorly thrown together parody of a much more popular game.
It does, doesn't it? But I can assure you it isn't.
For those of you who just woke up from a prolonged Rip Van Winkle-like coma, there are these things called Easter eggs, invisible buttons that you click with your mouse. There's one on the screen right now. Find it and click it. Seriously, don't make me tell you again. Alright, we'll click it for you, but remember to check the other tunes for them. Lazy little...
This death egg, Easter egg, is rather quaint. It's my robotic doppelganger, Tape Gun Mechami.
I've gotta get out of this Death Star.
Death Egg. Arg, it's the Skeletor. Can't be gonna hide. I think I'll jump into outer space. There's nothing wrong with that. Huzzah!
Why is the screen remaining dolphin gray for so long?
What is Gabber up to now?
Where are you going, mister?
I'm going to fly this biplane into the exosphere. There's nothing unscientific about that.
Oh man, well this is it. If for some reason an old friend with some miraculous timing doesn't manage to catch me while I'm falling at 11 miles per second through the exosphere, completely unharmed by friction, mind you, then I would like to admit one thing. Prodigious potion is completely harmless. I just wanted to sap those kids for all the money they had. It's really just sugar.
Gotcha!
I have been rescued! Chew! Chew, you pesky buzzards! I think it's almost time for me to strike a freaking cool pose! Huzzah! Bring back Sat-A-M!
That's the Sonic the Hedgehog cartoon from Saturday mornings. In the early 90s, it was so much better than all the other ones.
Hi, my name is Miles. I'm the director of this cartoon, and I just wanted to say that the ending to Sonic the Hedgehog 2 was the best friggin' ending to a video game ever! Honestly, there has never been a better video game ending. Since. Then. Period. You know how long it's been since that game was released? Oh, let's see. Oh, yeah, that's right. About 17 years! Alright? Think about that. Think about that for just a second. In 17 years, they have not made a better ending to a video game. Honestly! What? Come on! Come on! Well, that's it for me. Thank you for watching this tune. Bye-bye.
Well, it's about the time for Mogra's timeshare sales pitch, which means only one thing. Free buffet! Sketchy bombs, ovals, and ground pimples. Bad omen.
All razors fire! Take me, Godzilla!
You insult my intelligence with that pun. And now, as punishment for that random attack, I will induce China Syndrome! Take that, life on planet Earth. Come on, ceiling, this day up. Something tells me that uncontrolled vision isn't a good thing. Worst underground labyrinth ever. Maybe this will teach you to value property ownership over our love.
You can't escape the island until you hear our timeshare pitch.
I was under the impression that this was going to be a no-obligation retreat.
He is in charge here. I am so tempted to write a letter to the Attorney General. With your shield generator eliminated, you have nowhere left to run, General Riken.
Your complaints are very important to us. Please prepare for disintegration.
That's not good. Where's my smorgasbord?
You will listen to our sales pitch one way
or another.
Never! Can't you see I want to be alone with this laser cannon?
I am Mogura, director of the sales retreat. How can I help you?
You can start by not shooting at me.
No dice, lizard boy! No! Beep, 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 beep.
Listen, all I wanted was a look at the prime rib, but you have pushed me to the limit. I am going to return to the sea and leave such a negative score on your website that you will never be able to recover. For 30 days. Why do I always forget about the evil cell towers that block my escape into the sea? Why do you do this to me, Sprint? Why? Well, at least I managed to make an ugly scene. And certainly, that is the true meaning of an awful sales pitch, isn't it? Yes. Yes, it is. I still can't figure out what these things are. Oh well, maybe they taste good. That was rather unwise of me. That's disgusting.
Welcome to Toho Kingdom. It's really, really great. We've got kaiju and stuff, so stay up really late. Whee! Visit Toho Kingdom. Whoa! Meet our proprietor. He's an okay kind of gent. I like Toho Kingdom. Why won't you? It's so much better than the competition. What isn't Toho Kingdom? Toho Kingdom isn't a kick in the pants. Ouch! T-O-H-O space O-Koku! Watch out! Sanjuro has come to fight me. Will I prevail? And now I'm safely tucked in my bed. Nighty-night, Toho Kingdom. I can't get you out of my head. They will visit you. I command it. Even in the realm of sleep will I declare my admiration of Toho Kingdom. Visit Toho Kingdom. Sorry about the lack of a skip intro button. I have no plans to fix that.
April Fools.
Hello, and welcome to our pledge drive. I bet you didn't realize that Kaiju Critics was public broadcast programming, did you? Well, what did you think? There aren't any commercials, the sets are clearly made out of cardboard, and do you really think that this guy ever gets paid? Honestly! Anyway, today I'm joined by a seasoned actress. Legion, how's it hanging?
Hi, Gabra.
My name is Monster X.
Yeah, I know. It's a pretty stupid name, you know.
Anyway, we're trying to...
reach our goal of earning 10,000 yen, isn't that right, Eski?
Eski? Ha! That's wonderful! She took Monster X, turned it into Monster Xy, shortened it to Xy, and made it even cuter by turning it into Eski. I'm gonna call you Eski from now on.
You'll do no such thing!
Hey, Eski, why don't we put one of our callers on the air?
Ah! What was that for?
Sorry, I'm a bit nervous. Oops, I just peed myself.
Oh, I've, like, just hooked up the thing that makes it so we can hear the, people who are calling to donate, money to us.
Awesome! Let's put them on the bear. Oh, crap, I mean, on the air!
Hello, caller. How much are you planning to donate? All or some? We would prefer all.
Gina, how much do you plan to donate?
I plan to donate over 9,000!
What, 9,000?
Stop sending us crank calls, people. Memetic mutations are no joking matter.
Oh, really?
Get out of here!
Chocolate rain!
I like photos.
Anyway, if you don't donate, you'll miss out on such quality programming as Manda's Riverdance Hour.
What, they made an hour out of it?
Somebody actually made a donation!
$100!
Wait, what's the conversion rate to yen?
About 10,000 yen.
We've reached our goal! Let's all spend the money on a used Nintendo DS.
Yay!
What do you mean you don't have any used Nintendo DSs? Oh, very well, let's go spend our donations on stuffed animals!
Yay!
Special thanks goes out to Julia Faye this week for providing the voice of Legion. She really did an awesome job.
Oh, one more thing. I know a lot of you are sending emails to monster_x04@yahoo.com. Unfortunately, due to the increased volume of emails, I can't quite respond to them all. I'm very sorry about that. I know some of you are used to my personal responses of craziness and insanity and doom, etc. So, rest assured, scrubby little humans, I'm reading your emails. And, this one guy who calls himself the Pope of Randomness? Yeah, I tried reading your emails, but I cannot figure them out for the life of me. With all due respect, you're one crazy, crazy, crazy guy. I mean, like, totally insane. But that's all I wanted to say. I just wanted to, say that I can't get to all of your emails, but, thank you for sending them, and, yeah, keep sending them, please. It's great, you know. Again, that's monster_x04@yahoo.com. Thank you.
Doom and wonder! Welcome to Kaiju Critics, where 2Ks have never been funny.
Hey!
Well, the fan art contest is over, and I must say I'm impressed with the results.
We received a grand total of 4 pictures. What? It's true?
Okay, well, it's true. Only 4 people sent in pics, but guess what that means?
Does it mean I have to buy a cuddly bedtime plushie and reveal unto him my innermost desires? Because if it does, then I'm already weeks ahead of you on that one.
What it means is that we can show all of them. All of the pictures we received.
As you can see, this artist was trying to represent the madness of the current socioeconomic climate with this masterpiece. And with this one, the artist painted a rather romanticized bit of imagery portraying Great Depression-era poverty. And with this one, the artist was clearly experimenting with an abstract and modern reprisal of Victorian-era realism. Finally, this one represents candy corn. For reasons I've yet to determine.
All right, I'm never allowing you to do a commentary again.
Hooray! I'm free to go home and tell my stuffed poodle everything I learned today, which includes the Greek alphabet. Alpha, Beta, Gamma, Delta, Epsilon.
Thanks goes out to KingCaesar09, Tito, it might be Tido, I'm gonna say both of them, Zeke the Hedgehog, and Gigamoth5, aka Jeremy. We really appreciate your contributions. Of doom and wonder.
And here's my fan art!
The storm that brews has reached its pinnacle. The era of Monster X has come. Obey.
Hey, what are you doing?
I'm making a threatening video for all of my viewers. Perhaps I will ransom their lives, or maybe I'll just ask them for candy.
The latter is far more likely, and also somewhat nicer.
What?
I must admit, it is harder to release my Doom videos now that I actually have a real job. You all know who I am, you all know that I'm not capable of most, if not all of the threats that I make, and some of you chicks out there might think me quite the wooby. Well, let me tell you something. This wooby isn't giving up without a fighty whitey. So I'm going to go old school on you now and blow up something to show you that I'm serious. Prepare yourselves for an unnecessarily glowy and vibrant explosion that would make even Akira Toriyama blush.
Monster X, you clown! What are you preparing to do?
Explosion! Ha!
Hooray! I think you popped my popcorn! So you really spent all of your time doing this before kaiju critics?
A great deal of time. Spent primarily in Gorosaurus's basement, or living room, if the occasion permitted.
Man, Godzilla kicking your butt must have really screwed up your brain juices.
Why do you keep bringing that up? That was 4.5 years ago. Forgive and forget.
Good show. Now if you'll excuse me, your bit of nostalgic tunery has inspired me to brew up some prodigious potion. Huzzah!
Ah, finally. After 17 some odd episodes, I can finally rest and relaxate at the beach, far away from that cloaked freak Gamera.
Ah, much needed vacation. If you don't count on those personal days and sick days. Also, there was that grief day I took when the winter frost decimated my herb garden. Why did I plant it in September?
Huh? Well, as long as my vacation has been irreversibly ruined by this walking nightmare,
hey!
We might as well review Watchmen. Now, this movie has been dissected in every review, but there is one thing we really need to discuss, and it has to do with a part of Dr. Manhattan I don't think the casual moviegoer expected to witness. Something that warrants serious scrutiny.
That's right! We're talking about...
his voice!
What? I thought we were talking about...
what?
Never mind.
Anyway, his voice was so... ugh. Public broadcast radio.
And that was another favorite from Johann Sebastian Bach. It is now 12 a.m. on Saturday, May 2nd. I'm told that we have a birthday boy listening right now. Best wishes goes out to Alistair Archibald Roosevelt, who just turned 105 years young today. If you'll hold on for just a second, I have to get up and stretch.
Ah.
Okay, we don't want to have to see where that's going.
So, Monster X, what did you think of Watchmen?
I found some aspects uncomfortably sacrilegious.
So, what should we rate it?
Something out of something.
Hooray! Hey, Monster X, look! It's a full moon!
What? Oh no! Cool transformation sequence initiate!
Oh!
What's the wolf for? I am now Kaiser Ghidorah, and I will read a fan mail.
Hooray!
At school yesterday, my friend Joey and I were playing a guessing game. The answer she said is Concetipatune? Well, after she said it, everyone laughed. Susie Kong.
Concetipatune. Oh, constipation.
That is funny. That was funny.
Welcome to Kaiju Critics. We just saw Star Trek.
This is the first Star Trek movie since the 80s that has actually managed to keep my attention. I'm looking at you, Star Trek 9. My old favorite was Wrath of Khan.
And my old favorite was Voyage Home.
And mine was Revenge of the Sith.
Wait, what are we even talking about?
But this one is my new favorite. It was so shiny and pretty and shiny. And it made me want to make my own starship and travel through space. Just like Ludwig von Beethoven.
I'm just going to ignore that. Anyway, it wasn't quite my favorite, but it is still high on the list. And I think there's one reason we can all agree on. Plot!
Pointy ears!
And we won't do any random cutaways this time to prove our point.
Isn't that right, Communications Officer Biolante?
Captain, we're being hailed by a Klingon bird of prey!
Special thanks goes out to Gotengo X Godzilla from the forums, who was the first and most persistent person to recommend a Star Trek-related tune. Kudos.
Almost 3 years ago, on this very site, a cartoon touched the hearts of dozens. This is the story of Samurai Duel.
I worked on Samurai Duel back in 06. Back then, I was a plucky cinematographer with a great deal of spunkitude. If it were up to me, the whole tune would have consisted of one lens flare after another until at the very end there would have been one climactic lens flare to beat them all. Unfortunately, no one else seemed to share my vision, so... yeah.
How?
Huh?
I was one of the storyboard artists. I remember the plot pretty well. There were these two samurai that really didn't look all that different from each other. Actually, I think it was just the same guy copied and pasted. Come to think of it, this tune is a little racially insensitive. Anyway, then when the two samurai finish their duel, the one loses his outer garment and underneath you can see women's lingerie. Come to think of it, this tune is also somewhat insensitive to transvestites. Blast it, this tune is just plain offensive.
I remember when I first saw this tune, I was like, whoa, what is this? Why are these two ladies going at it with Ginsu knives?
I actually think that those are two male samurai.
Really?
Yeah. Don't you see the half beards?
That doesn't necessarily mean anything.
I was originally supposed to be one of these samurai, but I got caught at the last second, and this never has happened before!
Wow, you just can't let it go, can you?
Okay, I'll let it go. Actually, that feels a lot better.
I was the medical consultant around the set. Turns out that katanas can be somewhat dangerous if handled improperly. I found that difficult to believe at first, but we soon learned that those things are sharp. Come to think of it, playing with sharp objects very often leads to bad situations. That's why I never play with my extra sharp cheddar. Gamera!
Can I have a glass of water? I want my mommy! I'm scared of you!
Calm down, calm down. Your mom is right over there.
You're doing fine, sweetie. I want my blanket!
I never even saw this dune. Why are you even asking me about it?
I did. It was, well, you know, it had, this was the one with the monkey brains, right?
Well, I can tell you this. Japan may have the fancy schmancy monopoly on samurai films, but we've got the RCMP flicks covered up in the Great White North.
Yeah, whatever!
If it weren't for this tune, Titanosaurus wouldn't have hired Black Moth!
First, why do you care?
It's me.
Second, I do not recall hiring him!
Oh, well, would you like to see my resume anyway? Oh.
I don't get it!
I am not you.
Nor am I you.
One time, I found $3 just lying on the ground in the parking lot. They were just, like, sitting there. I went over to Kmart and I bought myself some Hostess cupcakes. Yeah, that was the best day ever.
And so there you have it, Samurai Duel in a nutshell. A tune that shall live on and on and on and on. Truly, it has generated a massive fan base, and will continue to do so into the future.
Chocolate rain!
That is correct.
Oh.